to take a shot of this. James against Porter, drives, spins, gets inside. It's good. It's 40,000 for LeBron James, the NBA's all-time leading scorer, with another milestone as the legend of LeBron continues to grow.
Over and over, not just his impact on the game, but the league, the organizations he's played for, his teammates, and the next generation.
It's been absolutely brilliant to sustain excellence over 21 seasons. And it doesn't come without incredible work and the support of your family. And there's the react. What a moment for the James gang.
And here's the standing ovation for LeBron James as he goes to the bench.
And LeBron James, first one ever to 40,000 points. Some closest sweep as you can get in terms of close games.
Hachimura is on Jokic and scores easily. Denver, we know how great they are at home. 24-5 on the road. Three games over 500, 17-14. Right to Jokic. The quick shot is good. James' help came a little bit late. Jokic surveying. Backs in. Now has plenty of room. Knocks down another shot in the paint. He's already taken five shots. Very aggressive looking for a shot early. Obviously from the 40,000, but at least for tonight. But it would stop the consecutive games with 10 points plus. Beautiful shot there from Jokic. Already three shots in the paint that he had problems with and had to leave the game the other night. Lob pass to Murray. Off of the corner, shot clock winding down. Murray aware of that, two to shoot. Just gets it off in time. Well defended that time from Reeves, but Jokic the offensive rebound and put back. Jokic looks up at the shot clock. One-on-one now with Davis. Backs in, spins. Nice feed inside, beautiful look. The timing on the pass when the double team came. For those of you who had the first quarter in your pool, you're a loser. Jokic backs in and bags it all. Beautiful shot from Jokic. The passing has been superb, and it's not just Jokic. In fact, Jokic only has one assist. Gets the feed from Jackson inside. There's another one. Sometimes it's easy to get your confidence going. Jokic, there's backdoor. Holiday throws it down. Jokic gets the rebound. They can hold it for the final shot. Lakers don't have a foul to give. Jokic slowly steps inside, lays it up and in. Porter's got eight rebounds to go with the 20 points. Just playing some terrific basketball recently. Murray gets inside. Scoop layup. Bank shot is good. And it's a two-point game. Darvin Ham wants to call timeout. Porter is doubled. Jokic off the bounce, fakes, drives, flips it up and in. Murray having a big third quarter, finds Jokic. Once again, a beautiful touch.
Digit assist for Austin tonight.
Dinwiddie back in. Russell picked up his first foul, is out. And Jokic finally knocks down a three. It's just, right now, the offense is playing like it's never played in the history of the league. As Jokic off the glass, banks it home, and Denver's regained the lead. They're up by four. Three posts up by the elbow, four on the shot clock. Jokic gonna have to put it up. Falling away, it's up. Shot, he banks it in. Another circus shot from Nikola Jokic.
I mean, Anthony Davis, there's nothing else you can do. The release point from Nikola Jokic. Behind his head, behind his shoulders. You're not getting to that one.
Including the 11 assists. Reddish on Jokic, spins, drives, gets inside, flips it up and in.
Well, he deploys that floater.
So they get one more challenge. Reeves in the front court. Reeves finds Hachimura, corner three-pointer. Shot won't go. Rebound taken away. Davis took it right out of Jokic's hands. Reeves skirts through the paint. Tries again, goes at Murray. Tough fall-away shot, got it! Austin Reeves with a difficult shot, and the Lakers go up by three.
I said it, Mike, last 12, 13 games, his level, they feel different when he's playing like this.
Lakers shooting 54%. Reeves is 7 of 10. Jokic goes at Hachimura, kicks it out in the corner. Justin Holiday hits a three. Holiday 11 points off the bench. We're tied again with 4.5 to play. each team with 30 plus assists. Some great unselfish team basketball tonight. Reeves to James. James powers inside. Banks it home. Oh, what a shot from LeBron James.
And they are just spamming this high pick and roll between Austin Reeves and LeBron James. If they can't stop it, keep going to it.
You know, he scored over 40,000 points. Holiday on the drive, kicks it back out, Gordon. Gordon, corner three. That's good. Aaron Gordon from downtown.
Wow. Mike, he was not close on his first three-point attempts.
He's shooting 29% from that distance for the season. Reeves to James, right back to Reeves, long three-pointer. Rebound to Reddish. And a ball off Jokic's foot. James drives, lost it, knocked out of bounds. And they say James lost it. James saying it was deflected, but it's a half-hearted argument, so I think he realizes he lost it. Points, 11 assists for Murray. Into the hands of Jokic, guarded by Hachimura. Jokic gets in the paint, turns, twists, flips it up. Shot is good. He's got 33.
It's a ridiculous finish. And the touch is just absurd. It doesn't matter if he's twisting left shoulder, right shoulder.
Hachimura, elbow jumper. Off the mark, rebound Murray. Double team. Good harassment there by the Lakers. Holiday getting some big fourth quarter minutes. Again, no Contavious Caldwell-Pope tonight. Murray looking. Shot clock at 5. Murray spins, turns. Jumper's good. Jamal Murray with 22, and Denver's lead is 5. This equals their largest lead of the game.
What a luxury to have if you're the Denver Nuggets, to not have just one guy, but two guys who can self-create like Jokic and Murray.
Davis shot blocked. Jokic right there, and he had some help as Gordon brings it into the front court. Holiday fakes. Holiday drives. Scoop layup. Banks at home. And it's a 7-point lead. They've scored 9 in a row.
This ability to get timely stops and keep your foot on the gas on the offensive end. This is the gear that the Denver Nuggets can hit.
Reeves to Davis. Step back jumper. Got it. Anthony Davis, a big bucket, cuts it to 5. Anxious moments for the Laker faithful. It happened so many times in the conference finals. Close games. The Nuggets made all the big plays down the stretch. Murray gets inside and banks it in. Sensational move from Jamal Murray. And a lead back up to 7. So the starting 5 on the floor for Darvin Ham. James fires away a three-pointer way off. And Porter with his 10th rebound throws it ahead to Gordon. And Gordon will bring it back out. It's gone quiet here at the Crypto.com Arena.
And if you're the Nuggets, there's no reason to do anything else but this two-man game right here. This is your bread and butter.
Murray, step back, three-pointer. Shot won't go. Gordon with the rebound. Big offensive board. They go inside to Jokic, and he banks it in. How about Porter recognizing the mismatch? And the lead is 9, largest of the game for the Nuggets. Under a minute remaining. James goes down a lane. Eurostep banks at home, and it's back to 7. Murray calmly walks it up the floor, despite the pressure from Reeves. Jokic hands it back. Jokic tips it to himself, backs in, flips it up. Oh, what a pass, and Gordon throws it down, and a foul. Looked like it was one of those flip shots from Jokic. Instead, a beautiful assist, and the lead is 9.
I'm on the money.
His decision-making is just sheer brilliance.
Savant. This is what we call a basketball savant.
And many in the crowd now heading for the exits. As Denver with a 10-point advantage. What a fourth quarter from the Denver Nuggets. Reeves misses badly. Rebound. And that's going to do it. The Denver Nuggets remain perfect since the All-Star break. This will be 6 wins in a row. And here in the fourth quarter, they shoot 15 for 22 from the field and beat the Lakers for the third time in 3 tries this season. LeBron James had his moment early. Much respect for the 2 future Hall of Famers as James passed the 40,000 career point mark.
I have it completely soaked in, you know, really just the opportunity of, you know, being around him every day, playing alongside him every day. You know, I kind of live in the moment, and, you know, later in life we'll probably look back and, you know, cherish all these memories and moments, you know, more so then than now, just because, you know, like I said, I'm living in the moment. But just to be a part of it, being, you know, the presence of greatness every single day, you know, everything that, you know, shines under the lights for the last 21 years, you know, starts, you know, when nobody's looking. And he's the first one to the gym. He's always getting treatment. So just being able to, you know, play alongside him, you know, pick his brain on, you know, the game, life, it's special. And, you know, there's nobody, you know, worthy of that enough than him. Yeah, I mean, it's just, it's greatness right in front of all of our eyes.
AD, LeBron's at 40,000 points. Do you think the person, or, you know, is there a person that can pass that? Have we seen that person, and, you know, do they exist, or would it be someone in the future, or will that never happen?
That can pass 40,000 or get to 40,000? I mean, you think about, it's got to be a young guy. I mean, you would think possibly Steph, the way he shoots the ball, but it's not. And it's just tough because he's not finished playing. So it's only going to increase, and, you know, that gap is only going to get bigger and bigger. So, you know, I was just telling him in the locker room, like, one, he might have to stop breaking records because we always lose on any time he break a record. And he said the same thing. But then, two, anytime he plays, is, well, I guess this one was more of a milestone than a record. But anytime he plays, like, it's going to be a new milestone every time. So I don't think nobody. I mean, and he went to 8 straight finals, you know, which helps you play longer in the postseason. You know, you're going to keep scoring. And then for him being a number option on his teams, you know, what he's able to do to score. But as of right now, I don't see anybody you know, breaking his record.
Happy for him, man. It was a hell of an accomplishment. Wish we could have got the win to cap it off. That didn't happen, but, you know, my hat's off to him. Amazing, amazing run that continues to this day. And, you know, everyone in our program, everyone within our organization is extremely excited and happy for him.
LeBron, do you think there's any other current player that's going to retire having hit the 40K mark? And if not, do you think it will ever be done again?
I have no idea. Obviously, you have to play the game quite a while and have you know, some good luck as far as injuries and things of that nature. You have to take care of your body. You have to be present on the floor. And then you have to be productive as well. Obviously, we have a lot of great guys in our league that can score the ball, and you know, if they were to stay healthy and they were to play a long time, then they can eclipse it. But, you know, you can't account for what could possibly happen. So I can't sit here and say, you know, who would it be in our league today? And then records are always meant to be broken. You know, it's, you can never say never of any record. You know, at one point we said that, you know, Big O's triple-double record would never be broken. And Russ did it, and now it looks like, you know, Joker and Luka, they're doing it every night. You know, it's just certain things that you don't think that's going to happen. But, you know, I guess for years people said Kareem's record wouldn't be broken, and I was able to eclipse it. But, you know, you have to, like I said, you have to have some really good luck. You have to, you know, play the game at a high level for a long time, but we'll see.
Hosted a girl dad night tonight, and so I was wondering, out of all the moments in your career, is there any that's been the most special because you got to spend it with your daughter?
I mean, it's definitely special when I looked up there in the stands and seen her sitting up there. And, you know, when the 40,000 point mark hit, definitely looked up there at my wife and looked at my daughter and my mom, and my daughter was just clapping and, you know, like pumping her arms up in the air. So that was a super cool moment. Blew her kiss. She blew one back to me. So that's super cool for sure. You know, she's the best. Definitely a girl dad, and you know, happy she's a part of the family. She runs everything. So what Z says goes in our household for sure.
Five to go. Let's see. Hopefully get this sorted out as Dallas lead is 105-98. Meanwhile, the Cavs need some stops here as Luka Doncic steps back. Loose ball grabbed by Klieber in a crowd. That's a big play there as Washington wheels inside. Finds an open Klieber for three, and Max earned that. Klieber has given the Mavericks a 10-point lead.
Wow. Again, offensively, they are one of the best in the league. And when they beat you inside for rebounds and things like that, it just makes them that much tougher.
The Mavericks run is 10-0. That ball comes loose to Allen. That's a big bucket right there. It escaped the grasp of Irving. And Allen was the recipient. Mavericks 108, Cavaliers 100. We approach the four-minute mark.
Opportunity now has to be for the Cavs on the defensive end of the floor.
Klieber sends it back to Irving. Irving finger rolls inside. Kyrie now has 25. He and Doncic have combined for 70 of the Mavericks 110. Struce. Back it goes to Mitchell. Takes a bump from Hardaway. Struce fires a three. He knocks it down. Klieber came out with a contest, but Struce finds his third long-range bomb of the night. And oh, boy, Irving stepped on the baseline, inbound into basketball, so it's a Maverick turnover, and believe me, the Mavericks have been really clean with the basketball tonight. That is only their fourth miscue of the evening.
And that's one of the reasons why they've been able to stay in control of the game, because of that. Oh!
The Cavaliers capitalize, and all of a sudden, that Maverick, a 10-point lead, has been trimmed all the way down to four.
It's amazing how things can change in this league.
That was the Mavericks' first turnover since the 8:36 mark of the second quarter. Irving long range. Oh, brother. Woo-hoo. Irving now has 28 points. He's knocked down five triples. Mitchell finds Struce. Struce looks to stay hot, and he does.
Find the open man.
Max Struce has five threes. Haymaker after haymaker. Mavericks by four. Irving baseline. He got squeezed out. Out comes Mitchell. He'll find Garland. Garland off to Struce. Struce with another. Oh, my word.
Shoot it. Supermax is on fire.
Unbelievable. Came in a 67-second span, and the Cavaliers are back within one. 2:20 remains. This crowd is on its feet. Doncic steps back. That's going to be short. And tracked down by Struce. He's been the man of the hour here in this fourth quarter.
You wonder about the Cavaliers bigs? We have a 7-foot guy guarding Doncic. It makes him shoot an air ball.
Mitchell with under two to go. Works on Washington. Garland fakes a three. Dumps back to Mitchell. He'll fire. He knocks it down as Donovan Mitchell has given the Cavaliers the lead.
Moving the basketball was a beautiful thing. Boom. Shoot that ball, Donovan.
Mitchell and the Cavaliers have offered a 15-3 run in less than 2 minutes. They offered a marvelous comeback to shock the Mavericks in Dallas 2 days after Christmas. Here's Irving. He's watched by LeVert. The Mavericks led by 10 just minutes ago. Doncic looks for an opening. He's doubled. Green missed the shot. He tried to draw a foul. Back from the Cavaliers with a 2-point lead.
It's called defense. exactly what it is, the defense at the right time.
Garland is watched by Doncic. The Cavs have made their last five threes. Garland gets right around Doncic to the basket. That's blocked by Kleber. Washington has his head up. He'll bounce off to Irving. Irving got called for an offensive foul, and it was Max Strus at the point of attack. Irving can't believe it.
Doing a super job of waiting and staying with it on defense. Coming in, he slides off on Irving. Irving hooks on right there. There's the foul right there.
Boy, that is a big call late, as we are now under a minute to go. The Cavs have the basketball in a 115-113 lead.
New possession opportunity here.
It's knocked away from Mitchell. Doncic back to Green. We're tied.
Turnover in the backcourt.
40 seconds to go. Garland is picked up by Irving. Mitchell is guarded by Green. Uses an Allen screen. Fires a three. And nails it. Donovan Mitchell, as the Cavaliers come alive from long range. Late in this ball game, you see the Cavalier run, as with 29 seconds remaining. He has played 38 long minutes. This man, Max Strus, has been a catalyst here in this final frame. Four threes in just over a minute to will the Cavaliers back into this game.
He brought the team back to life with his play. Those four threes have changed the whole feeling of the Cavs, especially on the defensive end of the floor.
The Cavaliers have two timeouts remaining. The Mavericks have one. Irving works on LeVert, gets inside, floats it up, and floats it in. That cuts the Cavalier lead to one. You can tell the Cavs there right around that perimeter. They advance into the forecourt out of the timeout. They'll send it all the way back to Caris LeVert. So the shot clock is off. LeVert bounces off to Mitchell. Cavs will play keep away here. Dallas looks for a steal. Garland, he's tackled. Whoa, by Green, nothing was called. And the Cavs take a timeout. Oh, my goodness. A tap. Mobley to inbound. The Mavs look to deny. Whoa, that ball's knocked out of bounds. Mavericks ball. Again, the Cavs were out of timeouts. Dallas will use a timeout here.
In this situation, you can't have anybody get an easy shot.
Kleber has that tip by Mobley, but Doncic gets it back. Doncic dumps inside Washington, puts it in. 2 seconds left. The Cavs are out of timeouts. They have to go 94 feet. Strus from midcourt. Oh, do you believe this?
Whoa. My goodness.
Max Strus from midcourt has won it for the Cavaliers.
The Cavaliers call up heaven for a prayer in his answer by Superman.
Both Gobert and Towns with five fouls.
He didn't give up the layup. That's the silver lining of that.
Barnes can't hit. Herter the offensive board. Monk in the corner for three, and it's good. 20 second chance points for Sacramento. They're back up by two. Gobert at the free throw line, gives it to Conley. And a foul is called.
Clearly in Sacramento's favor, 20-12 advantage.
Wolves trying to pull out a tight victory.
Yeah.
Their last nine wins, the Wolves have been by an average of 20 points.
Did the same thing for De'Aaron Fox at the end of game, last ball game here, bracketing the ball handler in pick and roll game.
Towns with five fouls, good contest. Monk can't hit, Gobert the board. Great defensive sequence from Towns. Here's McDaniels. Conley, little jab step, outside look. Nas Reed, no good. Tap out by Gobert.
Inside, Reed, Big Jello! Monk the answer, putting the Kings back on top. What a nail biter. This crowd looks exhausted.
Malik Monk has 33 in the game.
Conley on the logo. McDaniels, Towns in the corner. No good. Gobert tried to keep it alive. Herter has it. And now the Kings, with a one-point advantage, can add to it here. Monk gives it back to Sabonis. Rejected by Gobert. Tapped over to Reed. Wolves down one. 50 seconds to go in regulation. Towns. Inside. Gobert wrapped up. Pressure free throw to tie this one up at 115. And he does it.
Points for Malik Monk in the second half. He had four at halftime.
Barnes driving on Towns. Can't hit. Sabonis the offensive board. Dribbles out of trouble. Monk won't take the three. Penetrating inside. Herter extra pass. Sabonis gives it back to Herter. Throws it to Murray. No good. Gobert climbs the ladder, but a loose ball foul is called.
Differential is not enough
after
time for me.
There's illegal contact from Mike Conley to the arm of Sabonis. As a result, the ruling on the floor will stand. Play will resume with the Sacramento throw on the sideline. I don't want to.
Barnes to get it in. Monk, 33.9, 29 in the second half.
They're going to play it out.
And now it's Reed on Monk. Long distance three, air ball, out of bounds. 1.9 presently on the game clock. Conley. Into Towns. Tough turnaround. No good. And put five more minutes on the clock.
And they did a great job. Even when Ant was in the game, they thwarted Minnesota's ability to get to the rim. Done a great job here without De'Aaron Fox. Malik Monk has been fantastic here in the second half. 29 points for him.
As you mentioned, Jim Pete, both Towns and Gobert have five fouls, as does Domantas Sabonis. Murray will fade away, gets it to drop. Murray's been quiet in this ball game. He does have 15 points, make it 17 now with that jumper.
Sacramento just zone it up, making it hard for Minnesota with all the bigs on the floor.
McDaniels!
Oh, Jaden.
New career high for Jaden McDaniels. 26. Wolves by one.
5 of 7 for Jaden from outside the arc.
Murray swallowed up by Gobert. Now it's Sabonis. Attacking Reed. Help defense comes. Gobert took a shot. Who gave it to him?
Sabonis.
Crowd letting them know.
Falling on the back of Rudy Gobert.
Towns.
That's a foul.
Another foul. Malik Monk wants a challenge of the ball game. Three. Monk.
Good switch.
Oh, Monk left open. Ties it up.
Rudy was trying to tell Naz Reid to get out there, but didn't tell him soon enough. Naz was slow on the rotation. Rudy just left Malik Monk alone. That's a huge communication error right there for Minnesota.
Towns from deep. Rims out.
2:10 to go. Monk, three more? Yes, sir. He's been unreal. 39 points. 3-point advantage for the Kings. Reed nearly lost the handle. Driving, blocked by Lyles. Monk comes out of there with it. They can make it a 2-possession game. Monk. Driving. Kick out. Herter left open. Won't take the three. Sidestep. Short rebound Reed. Chris Finch calls timeout. Still a 1-possession game. That pass too high for Nas Reed. Wolves need another stop. Hard pounding action at Target Center. Fourth game of a 7-game homestand. Monk. Outside look. Lyles. Herter. No. Rebound Reed. And Chris Finch calls Minnesota's final timeout. Over to Alexander Walker. Penetrating outside look. Nas Reed, three ball, no. Lyles the rebound. And Towns quickly fouls.
1 of 6 for Karl Anthony Towns, 1 of 6 for Nas. But another miss here for Trey Lyles. Are they going to foul, though? That's the question.
Two possession game. Conley across the timeline. Fires the three, no good. And that'll do it.
The cell rattles out.
Good defensive effort there from Chet Holmgren.
And then Holmgren knocks down the triple. SGA in the paint. Victor got that one after Sohan went for the fake.
Backed him up all the way underneath the rim.
Jay Gilgeous-Alexander blocked away again by Victor.
Yeah.
Signal. Challenge. Yeah, replay.
They think they're unlimited.
Yes. Long ball inside. There you go. Victor Wembanyama and Vassell. That a really good connection of late.
Yeah. Starting off with a smaller defender trying to get physical with Victor. He's physical, but he's not tall enough on that one. Throw it right over the top. Nothing Jalen Williams can do. Easy layup for the big fella.
Trey Jones continuing to improve from the outside as Holmgren. Nice move inside. Zach Collins waiting to check in now. Holmgren. Got it by Vic and a couple of others. He sits with 2.3 rebounds, 2 assists, 2 blocks. Holmgren's got 11. Backdoor pass. And one coming up for OKC as Isaiah Joe gets the bucket. It's his first foul. And Blake Wesley will come on for Trey.
Number 14, Blake Wesley, in for Trey Jones. Isaiah Joe on the free throw line for Oklahoma City. 1 minute,
out on the lease. Both teams shooting well from three, and both teams 5 of 5 from the free throw line. Malachi blocked by Holmgren. And if he wants to continue with his association with HEB, all he's got to do is say, yeah, I'll deliver your bags to your car.
Sure.
Now, against Holmgren. Puts it up and in. Had to be a push-off, I guess. Williams to Holmgren. 7 shooting as well as 3 rebounds. Spurs lead cut to 3. Make it 6. Vic with the 3-pointer. First 32% is his shooting mark from distance.
Oh,
and another block.
First, second team. 2 places at once. Nice job just against you.
He finally wears you out. Vassell with a miss. Wemby right there to put it back in.
Jalen Williams was their best draft pick last year.
Yeah.
He's a phenomenal player.
Wemby rolls around and falls in on the baseline jumper. Wemby got the three ball. Wow.
Holmgren. Oh, it got tricky there. Put it underneath the arm of Victor. How many times are you going to see that? A guy at 7 foot two or three, putting it underneath the arm of the defense.
And then Vic drains a three.
Taking on their number one shot blocker. Beautiful spin move and finish.
His fourth 20-point game or better. Holmgren counters with a vicious dunk. 116-113.
Even when Victor fumbles the ball, he still gets something good out of it.
He fires. He scores! Oh, mama! Wembanyama! Bissell, back to Victor. Another three. Get out of here! Oh, my goodness! That was from Paris, Texas.
Yes, it was. He turned around and looked at the OKC bench. Maybe they were taunting him as he goes into that shot.
28 for Victor Wembanyama. Holmgren trying to answer. He is stuffed. Take it away!
Between the Heat and the Nuggets. Stephen Curry gets up the first shot.
Ooh, coach, he's got a little bit of that magic at MSG, doesn't he?
Curry leaves it now. Green gives it right back. Stephen Curry fires, and he's 2 for 2 from three-point range.
This is Steph Curry at his best, makes the pass, keeps moving. Too much separation there. Josh Hart not with him, Curry drains it.
9-0 start for the Nuggets, and a block on the other end. Kuminga and Green converge on Hartenstein. And now Curry fires once again. Uh-oh, Stephen Curry did not get a piece of that, says the officiating crew. That was a straight air ball, but Curry has hit the bullseye three times. Surprising to hear Tom Thibodeau today.
You're exactly right. If you throw him in the mix, coach told us that he is hopeful that all three will be back by the end of the month.
No, but an excellent call. A foul was before. Good call, and it was smart of them to look at it.
And Carl Lane kind of had it that way to start with, as Curry is fouled this time going in. Count the basket.
Jeff said, well, if you won't give me the three from distance, I'll figure out another way to get three.
Achiuwa had his arm right on top.
And help defense from Josh Hart to create that turnover.
Dealt with their fourth turnover in this corner. Curry quiets him down. After the way the game started, a 14-0 start. Curry hit his first three threes. Now he lays one in. Got to go quick if you're the Knicks. DiVincenzo catch and shoot. Kuminga just jumping over Hart. Now the outlet to Curry. Long three in transition. Wow. Oh, my goodness. The modern game. Warriors with the ball here, looking up top. Payton the catch. Hart with a deflection. Curry lets it fly and hits number six from deep range. Play by Draymond Green.
Here it is. Great defense there by the Knicks, but they knock it away and Curry hits one from that.
Clock's ticking here. Back to Curry in the corner. Curry hits a three. Warriors ball here.
You see it here. They try to shoot the gap.
No Randall, no Ananobi, no Mitchell Robinson. Knicks trying to weather the storm, but it's a Curry storm right now. Three-point shooting. Stephen Curry with another big night at Madison Square Garden tonight. 31 points.
Tice was signed in mid-November, and depending on the night, it'll be him or Mason Plumlee that's the first big off the bench as LeBron throws it down. He's a player who has not struggled out of the All-Star break.
And again, they want to get the ball to the basket. The beautiful slip there on the down screen from LeBron James.
Here's James firing underneath to Davis, goes right at the chest of Leonard and scores over him. And what a play by Davis, stripping Tice, reaching in and getting it away from him. And how about passing? AD to LeBron, underneath to Hachimura. The slam ties the game.
Lakers running the fast break to perfection. The throw ahead to LeBron to the cutting.
And all six of their baskets have come in the lane. Five field goals on six buckets. James backing down Powell. Ball away jumper. Front rim, back rim, and down. James, 2 of 2 from the floor.
It's twice now that the Clippers have been able to get behind the defense and make a play. One for a dunk, that time for a three.
Pass broken up by Powell beautifully. Coffee charging right. Reeves and the chase down swat from James.
Well, Dave, this never gets old. This never gets old, even at 39 years old. Watch him time this jump perfectly and block it off the backboard. How many times have we seen this? Him just slow down, gather his steps.
4 second difference in the game in shot clocks here at the end of the first. Westbrook defending James. Teammates for a little bit with the Lakers. James, tough shot, but it goes down and a foul.
These size mismatches. Here it's LeBron in the post. PJ Tucker a little bit late on that low side.
Here's Powell, walks into a three ball, way off, James rebounds, looks to push. James downhill, layup good, 12 for LeBron. Gets the Lakers back within seven.
Transition defense from his Clippers. Head of steam, LeBron James in transition.
Harden lobs it up there for Tice, broken up by Davis. James ahead to Russell, and Russell with the layup. 9 points now for D'Angelo Russell. Tice stripped by Reeves. Lakers looking to run. Hachimura attacking. He is ninth in the NBA in three-point shooting at 44%. James trying to answer, does. LeBron James with the three ball. 15 points now for him. Plenty of time and firepower for the Lakers. As James takes his time, drills it. LeBron now with 18, his third three. Not much life from the fans tonight. Really looking forward to the Intuit Dome next year. The new building for the Clippers as James hits a three. Actually hear a roar of the crowd with a lot of Laker fans here as they're back within 12.
Time, a lot of firepower, that's what you said. And it's been LeBron James.
And it's rebounded by Hayes. Chance for the Lakers maybe to get it down to nine. James for three! LeBron James heating up. The crowd coming alive.
Behind the three-point line. Back-to-back triples.
And now Plumlee running the break. Poked away from behind. Reddish forcing the turnover. James in transition. Catch and shoot. Russell for three. Lakers within seven. 11-1 run. Back to Plumlee. His pass intercepted. James now on the other end. Driving on Powell. Attacking Plumlee. Big shot goes. Lakers within five. At the end of the game clock or shot clock. James, top of the key. He hits a three. LeBron with 29, four threes in the third. Leonard with 22. LeBron's hit four threes in the quarter, the second time he's made four triples in a quarter. Anthony Davis was on the bench during that run. He's back out there now. He got Powell on LeBron. Shot clock at five, and now Harden switches out. This is what James wants. He gets past him. He drives. He hangs. Missed the shot. Got it back. Goes up. Flips it in with the left hand. James, 31 points. That's his 13th 30-point game of the year. And a foul called here as Terrence Mann hit the deck. They get James for the foul, his second. Clippers led by 21, seemingly moments ago. It was this quarter, but great run here by the Lakers to get back in the game. Mann in the paint, missed the shot. Davis got the rebound. 5.5 to go. Lakers ball down five. James, 12 of 17, 6 of 9 from three. Mann takes him on the switch, and now you get Harden on him again. Again, the matchup LeBron wants. Shot clock at 8. James gives it up, deflected by Powell out of bounds. 6 to shoot. 16 to 10 here in the fourth quarter to pull the Lakers within 5. They have 5 to shoot. Reeves steps back, fires to Hachimura with 1. He's got to put it up. Lets it fly on the baseline. And it's short. Rebound Powell. James Harden, 21 points, but the bulk of that came in the second quarter. Gets aggressive here. Missed the runner. Gets it back. Out to Powell for three. Misfire. Rebound, Davis. 10 rebounds for Davis to go with 18 points. Now James with Tice on him backs up to the midcourt line. LeBron rocking it. Step back. Three on the way. Bottom! LeBron James with five threes here in the quarter. Lakers within two.
How many times have we seen that signature step back three, hang dribble with the left? Oh my goodness, LeBron James, what a quarter.
19 points, his highest in a quarter this season, and he just knocked the ball out of bounds off Kawhi Leonard. LeBron James has taken over the game here in the fourth quarter on both ends. Lakers looking to tie or take the lead. LeBron coming to get the ball. Davis with the screen, so they switch Tice onto James again. LeBron fires away. Missed it that time. Offensive rebound, Davis. And fouled on the putback try. A chance to tie it at the line for AD. They've erased a 21-point deficit in about 6 minutes here.
The fifth three of this quarter for LeBron James. There's that signature move. And Dave, on the other end, in this quarter, he's taking the challenge. He's matched up directly with Kawhi Leonard. Previous possession forces that turnover.
First time in 4 years that LeBron has hit five threes in a quarter. He's got 34 points now. 19 in the fourth, the most in any quarter this season. As he continues to make the push towards 40,000 points. He's now 40 away from that. They play tomorrow night against Washington and then Saturday on ABC against Denver. AD ties the game at 106 with 4 minutes to go. Who will have the answer for the Clippers? Kawhi Leonard, guarded by James, drives past him. Goes around and almost turned it over. Deflected out of play by Reeves. 11 to shoot for the Clippers. Harden to inbound. Got to call a timeout or get it in quick, and he throws it away. Turnover by the Clippers. Lakers can take the lead as they erase a 21-point deficit in 8 minutes, thanks to LeBron James.
Year 21. Never take it for granted, Dave.
It is just amazing to sit here and watch. At age 39, year 21, the NBA's all-time leading scorer. Bring it when it matters most. They switch Tice out on him again. Shot clock at 10. Now they double. James forced to give it up to Russell. Hachimura open for the lead. No good. Davis got the offensive rebound. Back out to James. Shot clock at 8. James driving on Powell. Kicks it out. Hachimura again. Finally, the Lakers have the lead, overcoming a 21-point deficit here in the fourth. 109-106. Clippers looking to answer. 3 minute mark. Lost it. Now gathers. Shot clock at 3. Powell has to hoist. Poked away. Reed. Powell gathers and fires. And it's a shot clock violation. Now the Laker defense starting to step it up here.
And this is LeBron just making the right basketball play. Help off the strong side corner. You got Hachimura over there shooting over 40% from 3. That's the right play.
Davis sets the screen, forcing the switch. Tice on James with a shot clock at 10. Now man comes to double. Corner, look again for Hachimura this time. He drives, reverse layup, good. 5 Rui Hachimura points, gives the Lakers a 5-point lead. A 12-0 run. Starting a critical stretch of the bulk of their games at home, this would be a huge comeback win for the Lakers if they pull it off. They're outscoring the Clippers 34-10 in the quarter. James Harden finally gets the Clippers a basket. And it's a three-point game with two to play. 23 for Harden. James with 34 on 19 shots. Shot clock at 10 again. Tice on the switch on James. Shot clock down to 5. James gives it up to Reeves. Good look for 3. Can't hit it. Davis had it, lost it. Tice hustling, gets on the floor, but he rolled out of bounds. And it's Laker ball.
Good hustle here from Tice, but just no one to pass to. And eats the ball.
New shot clock for the Lakers. 90 seconds on the game clock. Leonard switches out. So Tice on James again with a shot clock at 15. They bring the double. They work it around to Hachimura. LeBron gets it back with a timer at 8. And now Harden switches out. Shot clock at 5. James to Russell. His 3 is good. And the Lakers lead by 6. It's contagious. It was all LeBron from deep early, Hachimura and Russell late, and it's 114-108 Lakers.
This is catch high, keep high. D'Angelo Russell, no wasted motion. Nothing but the bottom of the net tells the crowd to be quiet.
19-12. Simply amazing what we are witnessing. Bringing the Lakers back, although Leonard with a basket out of the timeout, and the Clippers still in it, down 4, just outside a minute to play. James had 15 points through three quarters, took one shot in the third. Every shot he's taken in the fourth has fallen. 7 of 11 for the game from 3. Timers at 5. James, step back 3. No good. Rebound man. Clippers ball down 4. Hachimura picking up Harden at the three-point line. Here's Leonard. He'll drive. Layup good with the left hand. Clippers back within 2. 12-second difference in the game and shot clocks. 114-112 Lakers. 12 to shoot, 24 in the game clock. Leonard on James. LeBron driving, falling away. Missed the shot. Rebound Harden. Clippers can tie or win this possession. T. Lou will not call a timeout. 8 seconds left, and now Lou will call it. 9.3 on the clock. That's the Clippers' final timeout. LeBron James defending Kawhi Leonard, who catches and drives. Clippers down 2. Fall away baseline. Short. Great defense. James gets the rebound. Ahead to Reddish with the exclamation point. What a comeback win by the Los Angeles Lakers. And it wasn't just LeBron on the offensive end. Made a great play defensively on Kawhi Leonard to knock it out of bounds when the Lakers were down 5 and then got the stop on the final possession against Kawhi.
Maxey fakes the 3, looking for a little space, can't find any. Here's Kyle Lowry, around and down it goes. Kyle Lowry with the reverse for his first points. Better start, Ala.
Watch this. He knows the shot clock situation, takes it right to the cup.
Win on that season-high 9-game win streak. They're 33-22. They're in the 4 spot. Sixers into 5. Kyle Lowry high off the window.
The ability at times to get some shots creates the space. Still learning the game.
Kyle Lowry finding Harris on the backside cut.
Not an easy catch either. Tobias.
Screening for him. 5 to go. Lowry downhill.
I thought Ananobi was just starting to kind of gel with his new teammates. That's going to set him back a little.
Lowry, the drive and the kick. Buddy Hield from downtown. A fight of who can fight off the fatigue the best tomorrow night. Here's Lowry. Kyle Lowry lays it up and in.
Mavericks, as we said, 6 consecutive wins. Kyrie Irving 3.
Guys on the floor here for the Suns that are the master of the mid-range game.
Well, you couldn't have more star power, could you? This, my goodness, step back 3, Doncic.
I don't know how you guard that.
Surgery during the break, and that's why he's got the mask.
You're going to see a lot of this tonight. Is that hot?
That's where he's made his money in this league, and he follows Doncic inside.
Help me.
Off that baseline and drops the anvil. Booker. Nice. Foul called on him.
Nice job. There's the dunk there by Lively.
Shot clock at 9 and inside. It's Booker knocked away. The defense by Lively. The run by Kyrie.
Oh, my goodness. Here, look at Kyrie switching hands. Oh, and the English.
And 8 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Third and final meeting this season. Doncic with a gorgeous three, and he's got a couple of them.
Defensively.
There's a drive inside. Doncic got it right there. Durant is out and Allen is in for the Suns, and a good drive here by Luka.
This is a rare moment. Luka going to his right and finishing. Usually when he's going to go to his left.
In the Valley of the Sun. A move, a drive inside. They couldn't get it to go with Jones, and they push it back up and in. His seventh point. It's Booker, intercepted. Picked up by Kyrie Irving. Puts on the brakes. Three is in. Neal, Eubanks, and a turnover. Six now, three, Irving got it.
Oh, okay, Kyrie. And O'Neal finishes.
Each team shooting over 50%. Hardaway.
That's going to continue to go up.
One quarter. Kyrie Irving slithers and finds room.
Shifty. Yeah, I was watching the...
Kevin Durant's got six. Fourth fastest.
Look at this.
28,000 points with a good-looking drive off that baseline and put up and through Kyrie 17.
Kyrie, look at this spin move off of Lee. You're going into traffic. You're going into the big boys.
Week of the game. It's Durant and Doncic. Luka, soft, too feathery easy. Shot.
Way too easy.
Doncic 4 of 8. Gordon defends. KD will back him up. Doesn't matter.
Oh, man.
Three is astray. Doncic the rebound. Quickly the other way. Kicking it. Green triple. Dallas gets another three. Timeout Phoenix. Then Dirk played for this organization. Big statue outside.
Well, earned and deserved statue.
Doncic!
Luka here on the drive again. When he goes right, he's pretty much going all the way, getting to the paint area. There's the contact, headed to the free throw line. See if he can pick up his 16th point.
There's so many great numbers on Doncic, but he has the fifth. Doncic shedding the defense of Okogie. Okogie sticking right with him. Around Eubanks. Got it. Foul. Count it.
He did the Larry Bird. Watch when he gets in and he gets them to Eubanks back. Watch the ball.
Ooh.
Yes, he did. That's old school Larry Joe Bird right there. Makes him look. There's the contact. Doncic putting on a show here in this first half, up to 18 points.
Two up. Durant is defending. Quarter three. A shot outside, put down Derrick Jones. We'll win the season series. They're only playing three games against each other this year. Doncic inside. Kyrie Irving. And Doncic from three, late closed by Booker.
Doncic will start to start this third quarter.
Because he's the more aggressive towards the rim out of the two. But on offense, he said they've been putting Kevin Durant on their center. So they want to use TJ more. And especially if they can get him in the pick and roll against Nurkic.
I mean, this is straight nasty right here by Luke. Is he going to go for the hat trick?
It's off to Washington. Three consecutive threes by the Mavericks. Timeout taken by Phoenix. Here's Josh Green. Doncic with 27. Allen is on him. Step back three.
Wow. Because you normally don't see that from Luka.
Picked up by Washington. Back to Doncic. And outside, Green three.
He is absolutely just spoon feeding.
Finding the shot by Washington. The triple won't go. Green, Irving, three. Bullseye!
Well, here's the problem.
Rebound, O'Neal fighting for it. Saves it inside. Green steals it for Dallas. Irving will pop a triple. It's the five for the Mavs as we start the fourth quarter. They got Nasir Little on him, and here's a pass, and a cutting Kleba. It's claimed in there. Okogie had it. Doncic fighting for it. It's rolling around and picked up. Great hustle on the play. Kyrie Irving. Here comes Washington slashing inside. Finds Okogie. Deflected. Good hands. Good defense by Dallas. Irving the other way behind the back and into Grayson Allen. Oh, what a play by Kyrie. Timeout Phoenix. He did a little bit of everything on this play. A wonderful display. It's a quarter three by Green. Answering the three by Durant. They had three turnovers the last 29 and a half minutes. I mean, it's amazing what they have done in that category. Into Kleba. Snuck it in. Got the deuce.
Too easy. Because right now, Luka is just picking them apart.
It's Kleba. Open three.
Look at all the three white jerseys on the spin move. And just finds a wide open Maxi.
For Durant.
Yep.
Very uncharacteristic.
87% free throw shooter. Doncic in tight. He's got 34. Three now. Washington knocks it away with pure hustle. In the corner, Green. Cutting is Irving. Good find by Green. Irving connects. Doncic fakes. Drives. And he gets it to go. Irving. Allen sticking right with him. Kyrie. Doncic, open three. The nail right there. It's over 41 points.
All-star for the ninth time. He was in Indianapolis, as was SGA. He's got the ball in his hands. For the Western Conference, Shea. That time, he got that step back three, and he sticks it.
And this is a chance for the Thunder to get out in transition also. Clippers are really good when they're just sitting there. And when you can push the pace and not allow them to dictate.
For highlights of the Thunder's best blocks of the season, visit OKCThunder.com/blocks for bucks. Shea missed free throw number two, but instead he'll step behind the three-point line and can the three.
With 2 minutes to go in this first quarter.
Going up against fresh Kawhi Leonard. What a move. Quickly splitting into that defense. SGA, and then goes up with that left hand. A little lollipop layup. Okay. This time it's Powell defending SGA, but SGA getting to his spot outside the block of the baseline. That one is good. Had another good look. And knocked down a couple of threes. Shea leans into that layup, going to work on James Harden. What a sweet move. Harden in and out on that three as SGA clutches the rebound. Trying once again push the pace a little. A crossover from SGA. What a sweet move once again. 53 seconds left here in this first half, but SGA short.
Just going back and forth between these two high-powered offenses right now in this second quarter. Both tied at 24 points apiece in the quarter, and it just continues.
Everything. The left hand. Seen a crossover, a little step back. James Harden can't do anything about it. Leonard, pass the three instead. It's Zubats, and Zubats denied at the rim by Chet Holmgren to give a little fist pump. George playing distributor, his fifth assist. Zubats now into double digits. Shea, little step back action, and he's got himself another three. As Powell also back in the game for L.A. Oh, Shea just glued him to the floor, and SGA once again from the mid-range. It's another to the highlight reel. We're getting physical inside.
Man, that's not an ankle breaker. That's like a runaway freight train by the.
Going right back to Leonard in the post. That time it looks like Josh Giddey. Trying to force the steal. Hot man rush. SGA on Powell. Off balance goes left. Still able to score.
Track meet so far in favor of the Thunder here. The second half.
So many hustle plays. That guy's like Jalen Williams. Four blocks on the night. Shea pulls up mid-range. That's good too. And the lead really starting to swell up here.
In this first minutes of the game.
As has Brandon Boston. Number four for LA. SGA squeezes through a couple of defenders. And another deflection.
You know what's funny is that the Thunder were trying to foul on that play to get the starters out of the game.
As you know, the Nuggets have lost three straight. They sit in fourth in the West. Now Jokic is in the lane, sets up Porter for a nice look for three, and he carries it.
That's what you do. You get him inside. I thought they...
Porter guarded by Avdija. Back to Jokic, and Jokic is in the lane and drops it home. I'd like to see Jokic taking a shot early. Been bothered by shin issues. Sore shins. Now Jokic has it. Koulibaly guarding. And Jokic floater, that's good too. And a couple straight shots. Kuzma, heat check. Round and out, another rebound for Jokic. Long pass. Gordon's out there. And he puts it away.
Wow.
Precision pass by Nikola Jokic.
Here's what's cool. Watch this. Gordon able to hold Kuzma off with the one hand, catch it one hand. Couldn't quite water polo it, Chris, but yep. Able to just still catch it one. Defense not set.
Tyus Jones off to a nice start.
Oh,
nice assist, and Gordon dunks it in there.
Joker was like setting up the back.
Jokic double for a moment. You saw KCP, took his tape off, got retaped, sitting in right in front of our broadcast position as Murray swishes one in. Murray looks, he's having a good year, much improved from a season ago. Now Murray's got it. Bounce back to Jokic. What a pass by Murray, who's averaging a career high 6.5, a second time they've had that this season. Now Jokic has it. Good pass, Christian Brown. Got it! A favorable home roll. Figures club. Porter with 18 to lead the parade. Nice pass and an excellent cut there by Christian Brown.
Well, it starts with a good screen, gets the guy off of you. Now you have to, your man has to go out on Joker. And if you're going to roll the basket, he's going to find you.
Jokic down the middle and over the top. Easy bucket. About a five-footer. Powered up, no. Hand off Reggie Jackson. Give to Jokic. Jokic faking and laying it in. And Bagley and subsequently traded him. Murray on the back cut. Here he comes. And there it goes. Boy, what a beautiful cut by Murray.
Dribble handoff. Look, they're going to cheat that side to the dribble handoff and just go the opposite way. Go the opposite way your defender is. Able to body control and lay it up.
Kuzma, tough shot. No. Another rebound to Jokic.
Go ahead, Joe.
Gordon coming in, and he lays it home. His 15th rebound tonight. Play here in the third quarter. Gordon ramming speed.
Oh, they're going to count that. He went into Kuzma on purpose. He thought Kuzma kind of bumped into him.
Yeah. 75-56. Jokic in the lane, flip it up and in. Joker going to work. His 12-point.
He makes it look so easy.
Jokic's going to take the 15-footer. No, he's going to wheel in. Scoop it. Oh, what a pass. A wraparound baby to his little buddy, Christian Brown. Porter, 14-footer, float it, no, tip it, yes, the big tipper going to work. And the Nuggets trying to get back on track here a bit. Murray with a little fall away, that's good. And Jamal Murray now before Denver. We'll see Chauncey and the Portland Trail Blazers tomorrow night. Jokic throws it up and in. Jokic with his 16th point. He hasn't missed a shot tonight, Scott. Did you know that?
He was a trainee.
Almost too unselfish for the Denver Nuggets.
Watson, another block. He goes ahead of Nikola Jokic. Watson.
Peyton Watson is flying.
Getting off to a good start, hitting the ground running is the term he used. Holiday for three. Got it. And Jokic, another assist. Jackson into Jokic, he's got it. To turn, and he puts it up and in. And 19 to go down. Jokic hand off to Gordon, back to Jokic. Jokic in the lane, and that's the easiest basket he has had tonight.
Bell for the dunk.
That's something we see from our squad with Domantas Sabonis handling the rock. Looking for that movement from the guard. This time, oh, he put Zach Collins on the poster, framed it, and stuck it on his bedroom wall.
Victor Wembanyama has been on the floor. I think he's only got Domas one time tonight, but Domas challenging him at the rim has been just so critical for the Kings offense tonight in the paint.
Domas 29-9. Vassell, meanwhile, has 29 points. Wembanyama getting a break here. He only plays about 30 minutes a game or so. All right, we're back underway here. Two-point game. Harrison Barnes, shot clock winding down, now at 10. Little go screen by Kevin Herter. HB, he got it.
They're challenging San Antonio's defense at the rim. Quiet night for Harrison tonight, but you can always rely on him to step up in situations where there needs to be a play made.
HB coming off that 20-point game last week against Denver. Quiet game for him, but they haven't needed a whole lot of scoring, but needed that free throw as it's still a one-possession game. Under four to play here. First game after the All-Star break for both teams. Johnson ties it at 114. Keldon Johnson has 18.
The Kings absolutely have to be able to get consecutive stops. You need 3-5 stops in a row here down the last few minutes of the game to try and gain some separation.
Domas tipped up. Let's see if they give him a rebound for that. I think so. That'll be a 38 straight double-double for Domantas Sabonis. Wembanyama. No. Under three to play now. Sohan being a pest. Forces the turnover. Wembanyama hacked and one. Wow. HB with the foul. And Victor Wembanyama a chance to give the Spurs the lead.
Since November, in terms of how he looks at the game and how this team has developed and are playing together, and it's because of a rookie that has been able to really lead that charge.
That free throw gives the Spurs their first lead since it was 39-36 at 8:58 in the second quarter. Oh, no, Wembanyama, the rebound. He's got 13. Here comes Vassell. Gets caught up in the air. Trey Jones trying to snake the baseline. Shot clock at three. Vassell got it. Big three. My gosh. He's got 32. Kings playing with fire right now, Katie.
Absolutely. You don't want to mess around with this team. They've got confidence. But Malik Monk stepping in, making a big basket to bring the Kings to a two-point deficit here. You have to get stops at this end of the floor. You're under 2 minutes. Kings have not been able to do that consistently throughout the game.
Wembanyama catch and shoot. All right, Kings get one stop. Here comes Malik, guarded by Sohan. Using that Domas screen. Sabonis has to kick it out. Fox, step back, sets the feet. Three, half money for number five.
And thinking about that shot right there had to be time for De'Aaron Fox to kind of get his feet set. He knew it was a big one, and he had the time to knock it down. Nothing but net for Foxy.
This Golden 1 Center crowd on their feet for their king. 1-point lead. Wembanyama, no, was looking for a foul. Under 60 to play. Oop-tai! Keegan taking the oop from De'Aaron.
Vassell, because he's going to be someone they're looking for, but also look for Wimby at the rim.
19 triple-doubles for DeMontis Sabonis. 38 straight double-doubles. Here's Sohan looking for Wembanyama. Nice denial by Keegan, but Vassell ripped by Swiper.
De'Aaron Fox with the finger wag right there. Absolutely coming up with a massive stop.
One possession game, however, Fox, fourth quarter time. Yes, sir. Up by five, Spurs out of timeouts. Scoop, counted by Trey Jones.
Last thing you want to do if you're the Kings is foul. If you get the ball back on defensively, have to go up against this Spurs team. But right here, use the clock,
yeah,
use the ball.
Yeah, got a foul here.
Getting the steal, knocking down the bucket. He has been fantastic. He's saving possessions. Those are not easy buckets to make, but Malik knocking down the free throw when it matters.
Kings 10 of 14 from the lock. Back to a 5-point game. Sohan airballs one, and Sacramento will improve to 32-23 as they begin the post-All-Star break stretch with a lighting the beam ceremony.
Sixers, Kuz goes all the way, gets knocked down. Here we go on the break. LeBron down the middle. All the way to throw it down! LeBron James!
Having guys, we look at LeBron, take it the distance. Nobody really wanting to get in front, and the result is
Holmes, Rashawn Holmes. Here comes LeBron with the left hand slam! Much better in the key than he used to be, but they pick his pocket. Taken away by Rui. Couple of big steps. Hachimura. Oh, and right there to get it is Davis. There's a lot going on under there in the mixer. What's 3-point percentage among players with at least 300 three-point tries? That's how much he's been struggling there. Counted it. Just counted. Anthony
Davis to clean it up and gets the loose ball, throws it up, throws it in, and earns himself a free throw.
Right. Worst defense. Actually, this is one of two teams, Washington, who's bottom five offensively and defensively. The only other. Both teams shooting over 50%. Jackson Hayes is in the game for the Lakers. As is Max Christie. Go to the basket, LeBron, to lay it up and in. It was the biggest comeback in LeBron's career for a team that LeBron has played on. LeBron's got this one for three. Boy, he had it rolling last night.
And that's pretty much the same.
Rui is back in, and Rui's former team, Washington, first time he's played against them. LeBron all the way, counted. Boy, didn't have much room under the hoop, did he?
Just aren't capable of keeping people in front of him.
Who's his season high is 38. Rui at the other end, picking up the garbage underneath with some good work. They've already beaten the Lakers twice this year. They're on a roll over Los Angeles. Reverse layup, Anthony Davis. He takes a tumble. Reeves. Oh, defender fell down. I don't know if Shamet was going to have a chance again. Davis.
Yeah, I wouldn't have to get the ball to Anthony Davis right there.
Pull up mid-range.
Even though he's effective from there, he can get it deeper.
Four games for them. Mid-range AD, that's usually money, and it is. Cash right there for Anthony Davis. Stop is by Abdia. Leaking out is LeBron. LeBron to the rim. Here he goes. Hanging the air and score. The whistle. LeBron gets up.
Have to go out. Make him put it on the jet.
Nine of his 15 points via the three. Look out with authority. Look out below. Anthony Davis on the way.
What else? Another look at the little drop pass by LeBron. Ooh. And that, I mean, monster flush by Anthony Davis. Get out the way.
Known for his passing. Now it's LeBron. Nobody's picking him up, and he goes around two to score.
Yeah, I love it.
Out on top to Christie. 86-85. Max. Look out! Look out!
Here comes Davis. Now Max has an assist.
You got in Christie not having a stat, and he makes a nice play to AD for the easy flush. As you mentioned, 30 points on the evening now for Anthony Davis.
On Saturday only. Oh, Reeves. Buckles it away. But it goes right to Anthony Davis. He's underneath the score.
Now that's footwork. That was some nice footwork, though.
Don with Russell, Jackson, Hayes, Prince, and Dinwiddie. So Lake Show fans, here we go. LeBron starts the quarter with a jump shot baseline. Marvin Bagley, that was drafted number 2 overall. James, oh, look at that soft touch as he was bigger the Joker. He's good to go. LeBron all the way, gives it up to AD to finish it. They're going to get Poole back in a moment. Lakers will get Dinwiddie on. LeBron taking charge. Reeves, LeBron. Oh, that was an offensive foul. Yeah, so that was 22-minute, 8 clocks moving. James, Davis, Lakers lead it. 131-128. One of the plays of the game, without question, to tie it up. He's got it. Defense at one end, hidden from downtown at the other.
Clowning around right now.
D'Lo bounce, LeBron, here he goes. Great dish. Finish AD, slam dunk.
Well, they don't take the time.
They have not been a great offensive rebounding team, per se.
Curry, right out of the gate for the Warriors with a triple.
Both these teams want to run.
Curry.
Got another. It's a three.
Now this is, you know, what do you do here in the last game? We destroyed Anthony Davis.
Hachimura comes up short. Oh! What a dazzle! It's Curry to Wiggins for the big finish. What a feed.
Look at this. He knew where Wiggins was all the way. The Lakers with no one back. 5 fast break points already for the Warriors. Pace of this game is going to be very fast.
First meeting, big difference, free throw line.
Steph Curry, smoking hot.
Now you see where Davis is. He's back on the pick and roll. Green does a great job twisting this screen. Setting it on the other side, and Curry gets a good. And I like it when he's around the basket.
Fade away. Hot Curry.
5:35 remaining in the first. It has been an exhibition from Curry.
Wow. 10 points and 5 rebounds already.
Curry, the banker goes. Steph Curry.
Every night, and he's done it, and Curry there going.
Looking to get things ignited. Klay Thompson has come off the bench and missed his first 3 shots. Curry. Oh, yeah!
Player like Steph Curry. Here's the deep 3 against the drop, and that's what creates problems.
Curry. Give it up. Looney. Contact. Wheels inside for 2. Okay. Steph Curry back in for the Warriors. Looking for an opening. No way.
Jackson Davis hammers it down. And another tasty dish from Curry.
46-44 Lakers.
28 in the paint already.
Šarić gets inside.
Kachemski swing, Green directing traffic. Curry down low, creative.
Running off screens and moving without the ball. They are impossible to defend.
That's on the Warriors. We're ready for the dive by Davis. Curry whips it to the outside. Wiggins does it himself with the floater. 60-54, Warriors in front. A minute and a half to go in this second quarter. Curry, another Steph Curry. Points for Steph Curry. The Warriors have their largest lead. It's a masterclass. scorching. Blocked by Wiggins. Great opportunity. Curry for two.
High man is Davis with 15. Russell has 10. No LeBron James out with the left ankle injury. Kuminga answers with a triple. Lakers will play 8 of their next 10 games at home. Russell threw it right to Curry. Now it's a race to the rim, and Curry's going to win.
That's Curry's third steal. OKC, you get the number one seed in the West. And you might have to play a Warrior team with Steph Curry, one of the best postseason players.
So Green handles it, directing traffic, tend to shoot, Curry.
Throw your hand up, Drew.
That's why you practice and practice and practice. Kennard unfettered to the rim and breaks the tie. 91-89, 3:29 to play in the game. Clippers just 4 for 16 here in the fourth quarter. Memphis 7 for 13. They'll score the Clippers by 6. Leonard at the foul line. A whistle and a foul. Just the second for Memphis. The Clippers, the next whistle will be over the limit. Here's the second foul on Williams.
Got him again. You know, over the summer, I'm going to talk to Vince a little bit. It's the solid defense. Don't go for, not right now, but that time Kawhi able to induce Vince Williams to kind of reach down after the ball and picked up the foul, kind of bailed out the Clipper offense that time over Stagner.
George for 3. Bullseye! 92-91, Clippers by 1 with 3 minutes to play. Clippers out in front by 1.
Well, now we need big-time defense to get multiple stops here so we can grow this lead a little bit more.
Kennard for 3 in the lead. Misses everything, and Terrence Mann with a rebound. 2:42 to play. James Harden brings it across. Harden runs into Williams. It was just the third foul for Memphis.
Why? Yep. Oh, see, it's coming from the opposite side. See, that's where the official came in. Watch right here. The push. It was, I mean, Kawhi did extend his arm. So I thought he was going to get away with it right there. See, from that angle, it doesn't look like it. But from the opposite side, you can see the push a little bit. And the weak side official picked that one up.
Second foul on Kawhi, the 21st Clipper turnover tonight. And they are just 5 for 17 here in the fourth.
Great defense here. Great pressure this time by the Lakers.
Jackson inside, lays it in. Memphis by 1. Williams comes out to half court to pick up Leonard. Kawhi for 3 in the lead.
I can imagine him trying to go back to this matchup here with whoever's guarding Jaren Jackson Jr. right now, way out on the perimeter. Double team.
The crowd getting loud, on their feet. Intercepted by Kawhi. It's a foot race. Oh, he thunders it in. And the silence is loud with 1:35 to play in the fourth. Clippers lead by 1.
An excellent double team that forced that cross-court pass, and Kawhi timed it up. Zoo is trying to make his entry back in the lineup and almost a turnover.
Jackson recovers. Spins his way down the lane. Pocket pick by Harden. Coffey. Man, right place, right time. Timeout Memphis. They are showing their teeth defensively here in the fourth quarter. Jackson. Fouled by Zoo. He'll go to the line for 2. 5 so far here tonight from the line.
He'll shoot to that 82% for the year, so that's an added bonus when your center is shooting 80%+, knowing that he'll have a lot of touches at the end of the game.
One-point game, 107 to play. The crowd again, once again, on their feet. Harden. Coffey back to Harden, seven to shoot, under a minute to play. Harden for three. Oh, yes! Harden knocks it down, and the strings make an evil hiss and silence the crowd. Jackson. Tough shot. Rebound goes to Kawhi. Leonard. Terrence Mann with the rebound. And the Clippers will take time off the ticker.
And early, they let time go off the clock. Great for us, but a little clock mismanagement right there by Memphis that benefits us now. It took off about 7 seconds.
What a comeback here for the Clippers. It hasn't been pretty until maybe the last 3 minutes. And I've said before, I like these games for the Clippers for this reason: the experience and executing. And tonight with a different lineup without Norman Powell on the tail end of a back-to-back. But at some point, the Clippers are going to have to play a 48-minute ball game. And as they come down the stretch, 101-95. Clippers need to run through the tape here. Kennard for three. That'll do it. Clippers have it, 4.6 to play, 101-95. In a game that was sloppy for the Clippers, 21 turnovers. They trailed here in the fourth, battle back, and they win 101-95. Clippers 7-0 going back to
Kucevic. Here comes Cleveland. Another tight Cavs-Bulls matchup down to the wire. It's been Heartbreak City the last seven times these two teams have met. Mitchell, the kick, intercepted by White. Shot clock is on.
You nothing behind you?
Whoa, oh, Mitchell knocked it away, and DeRozan recovers it. Woo. A chance for the win.
Gotta go, gotta go, gotta go, gotta go.
Six left. It's DeRozan. DeMar for the lead. No. Off to overtime we go. With Mitchell, but it ends up being a switch with Vucevic. DeRozan tries to get it on Garland. The rotation led to that Garland look.
Because you had to help Vuce on Donovan Mitchell.
Yep.
And that just made a whole domino effect.
Exactly. About Garland, 7 of 12 from 3 tonight. Season high, 7 triples. For a guy who's not shot the ball great this year, but as Stacy mentioned, was dealing with injury early. Vucevic spinning on Mobley. Got it to go.
Good move. Good move by Vuce.
Big fourth quarter and overtime for Vucevic. He's got 24 now.
Back-to-back solid game for Vuce.
Yep.
And if you're the Bulls, you got to avoid these switches.
Yeah.
Can't switch. You got to be straight up.
Because that's what Mitchell wants now.
Right here.
Yeah, he wants the switch. Good job by Dosuba to stick. Struce. And DeRozan. Good job by Vucevic to deter.
He got back in there.
Batum up ahead. Dosuba. Vucevic drives on Mobley again. And that's picked off by Garland, but he couldn't squeeze it. It's a break for the Bulls. Right idea by Vucevic, but he's frustrated at himself because I think maybe he thought he should have just taken the shot.
Here, trying to make a play right here. And he sees, he's at the corner of his eye. He knows Isles in the corner. They know where everybody is. So he thought he was going to make that pass over there. Cleveland with those active hands.
DeRozan has played 42 minutes tonight, the league leader in minutes played. Kobe White's number two. Drag step, kick to Batum, two on the clock. Batum hangs and will not get it to go. His first miss of the night after being put into a difficult spot late in the clock.
I wanted to shoot that three. Just let it go.
Would have been tough here in that corner, though, against Mitchell.
And right there, just pull up now. He's trying to get to the basket. Just pull up.
I mean, this is essentially his NBA debut. I know he appeared in two games for 6 minutes, but in garbage time. This is a real debut. He had to leave to go to Spurs, so that opens up LeVert again, and the Bulls are on a rotation for another trip.
Yes. Got to stay true defensively here in overtime. You cannot get caught off your man.
Here's Dosunmu. Got it.
Niles woke up on offense.
He's got 11 points since the start of the fourth quarter.
All right, they're stopping. You got to stay true.
Because you're trading threes for twos now. Yeah. Now you need stops.
Here comes that big screen and put Vooch in the pick and rolls.
White trying to stick with Garland, but Vucevic switched.
Oh, no.
Garland dancing with Vucevic. Did he knock it off of him? He did. Credit to Nikola Vucevic, who stood in there against Garland.
I'm telling you, that's still a tough defense right there.
It is very tough.
If you're Billy Donovan, if you're putting him in that screen, I'd just go blitz him. Blitz him, get the ball out of his hands. You can't keep Vooch out there switching. They're running it every single time.
DeRozan to tie it. Vucevic tapped it. Whistle, and it's a foul on Vucevic, and he is fouled out of this game.
Wow. Did DeMar get fouled?
Here it is. Depends on where Strus and when he made contact. Called Vucevic for that foul over the top.
Let's see. Again, that's it. That's tough.
At the end there, too, maybe Strus with a hand on the wrist of some or something. I know that's what DeMar was looking for. So Vucevic fouls out, 24-13. Drummond is back in with 15 points and 21 boards, and you can see Vucevic's frustration.
Well, it's not over. You got to get up and play some defense.
44 seconds left, and the Bulls are down. A massive situation needing a stop. Mitchell sees the clock, goes to work, and scores again. Late in the game, when you need a bucket, no matter how quiet he's been for three or maybe even four quarters, Donovan Mitchell knows when to come up and deliver.
Well, you see the difference now with when Vooch is in the game, they want to put him in the pick and roll. Vooch is out the game, now they go guard to guard, switch, and now we want to get the matchup that we want on this end with Kobe White. Here it is right here, opens up. And right now, and somebody's got to go. Somebody's got to help him. Because you got to remember, this is an all-star caliber player.
At 8:30, Bulls down four. DeRozan drives and scores. Two-point game with 21 seconds left. J.B. Bickerstaff screaming for a timeout. He'll use one of the two remaining here, and they'll advance the ball. On the foul situation here.
Let's see if they go to LeVert in the backcourt.
Cleveland the bonus. Here's Garland in the backcourt. Running clock. LeVert, Strus, Mitchell. Precious time taken away. They got about 8 seconds off the clock there. Short. Drummond with the rebound. His 22nd of the night. And the Bulls still have life.
A one possession game with a lot of time on the clock. Up to the basketball.
Yep. Bulls out of timeouts. Cleveland has a foul to give. Dosunmu to inbound. They get it to DeRozan. Forces it up and it gets fouled by Jared Allen.
I told you. J.B. Bickerstaff has to be right now. Three free throws. He's got to be scratching his head or rubbing his head. He doesn't have any hair, but rubbing his head because this is not what you wanted here. You wanted a foul quick. And there he is right there. That's a clear foul.
It's going to be three shots, as you said. Stays clearly behind the line. Wow. So here is DeMar DeRozan. 8 of 9 at the stripe, but he needs all three to tie it.
The one thing in a timeout you had to been telling your players, do not foul the three-point shooter.
Especially a three-point shooter, right?
Yeah, because it seemed like he was trying to foul to get the take the foul, but he was too late getting out there.
And DeRozan, the savvy vet, was able to draw the contact at the right time. This is the big one to try to tie it. Mitchell and Garland are back in for Cleveland.
Remember, he hits his free throws. Still a lot of time for Cleveland. They're going to get the last shot.
And they still have a timeout to advance. DeRozan needs this one, though. Got it.
There you go, D-Bo. All right, let's go. Got locked up.
They will not call timeout. Tied at 115. 3 seconds left. It's Donovan Mitchell.
That's offense.
For the win! My double overtime! He got plenty of free basketball for you. Drummond wins the tap over Mobley. White against LeFert. Fakes the three. DeRozan drives it instead. And reverses it home.
What a move. The marvelous DeRozan. Coming up huge. 26 points. Yep. Seven assists, nine rebounds.
Seven in the overtimes for him now, Stace. Strus. Curl. Shoot. Catch. No rebound. Kobe.
There you go. Take your time now. Execution important here.
Bulls' biggest lead was four. White spins, almost traveled. Got it to Batum, though. Now it's Dosunmu late in the clock. Needs help. Here's DeRozan with three.
Gotta go.
Forces the three.
Oh! You need a big bucket. Find the veteran, DeRozan.
Warriors, Donyell Marshall, Tyson Chandler, Eddie Curry, and Jamal Crawford.
Oh, man. Wow, you went really deep there.
Deep into the archives. Mitchell, high arcing. Three is good. Strus, short. And, oh, after the, and after the Bulls,
that's suffer. 26 rebounds?
It's 26 rebounds.
74!
And here.
Good job by Maxey to not foul on that shot. Make Bridges make shots.
Tyrese, the pull-up, and the finish. Maxey for three. By the Hornets. Mo might have been fired up about his first start. Bridges loses his footing. Lowry quickly ahead to Maxey. Tyrese dumps it off to Tobias, who ducks it down.
Watch this, the other end of the floor, the turnover from Bridges. Gets it to Lowry, who finds Maxey, who gets it.
Season good, rebound by Tobias.
Good inside position from Toby, block it out.
Hornets 0 for their last six from the floor. Tobias, catch and shoot triple.
Nice find from Buddy Hield. Tobias stepping on that there.
You impress me more and more every night we
even with
together.
Double digits.
The skip from Hield to Harris. Tobias has another triple. Eight and counting tonight for Harris.
Well,
Hield and Curry, a couple of the best shooters in the game today, going toe-to-toe. Maxey had to get up for that high pass, but it doesn't matter, because he's Tyrese Maxey.
No, going from right to left and having to bring the ball back across your body in front of the defender. Nice soft touch while on the move.
Last eight for him, as it was a two-point game. Tobias pushes it back.
Got a man beat. Do not allow him back into play.
Great cut from Maxey, and the reverse falls for Tyrese Maxey. Beautiful pass as well.
He was open. Arrival to or return.
Yeah, coming back from being injured.
Has certainly helped the defense.
Tobias looking for more. 13 first quarter points for Tobias Harris. And that is exactly
reportedly set to sign Nets assistant GM Jeff Peterson as their head of basketball operations.
Another great cut and a good find. Harris dunks it down.
Himself, but he's gotten his other teammates engaged offensively when they normally wouldn't be.
7-0 Charlotte run. Payne to Maxey. Tyrese Maxey, just when the Sixers need a bucket. Tyrese. First start as a Sixer tonight for Lowry and Mo Bamba. Harris. And Tobias gets the roll. 17 and counting tonight for 1-2.
Starts off the second half.
24%. Harris. Skip, just like you talked about a few moments ago. Look opposite, Kyle Lowry for three.
Big body, Richard, so he can finish around the rim because he's long.
Maxey, high arcing floater, no. Oh. Tyrese gets his own rebound, not once, but twice. And just like that, Richards has 14 points. Lowry,
looking opposite.
Skipping passes all over. Harris to the cup, and Tobias has 19 tonight.
You can see the Sixers.
Alone. And Bobby said, I'm really not happy with our individual defense. Everybody needs to get more pressure on bodies right away. We really have to test their drives. We got to test their physicality every single possession.
Well, Tyrese Maxey did just that.
Challenging, no open looks for these Hornets shooters.
Under 5 to go, third quarter. Pass a little behind Paul Reed, he gathers. And we'll give it back to Lowry. Maxey, step back, corner three is good for Tyrese Maxey.
There's the three over toes crossed.
That is our hope as well, big fella. Tobias gets the roll, 21 and counting. Taryn Holland, Kate with you tonight. Thanks for tuning in to NBC Sports Philadelphia for this one. Great pass from Paul Reed. Good cut from Harris. And a fine finish.
It's good to have someone as smart and knowledgeable, the old sage.
Good to have this guy too, 26 now. They hosted the Bucks last night. The Bucks were up big, but they would not go away, and they cut the lead to single digits late in that one before Milwaukee eventually pulled away.
The defense with this version of the Hornets is better than earlier versions.
Oh, what a pass from Paul Reed. The finger roll from Maxey.
He has to take, though, before he gets the benefit of the doubt. That's the only worrisome part.
Lowry finds Maxey behind the screen, and Tyrese knocks down his fifth triple tonight. They rule it a three, so that's his fifth triple tonight. He's got 25 Hornets on an 8-0 run. Tobias, tough turnaround on the baseline, and it goes. Maxey with three to shoot. At the shot clock, Tobias Harris, a massive bucket. Have him talking about a win here tonight. Gotta get it in, and they do. Trey Mann turning the corner, and what a defensive play by Tyrese Maxey. What a play by Maxey.
Mann on the drive, and then from behind, just gets him.
Until you really get to play against him and continue to see his tendencies as players throughout his time in this league. Great lob there from Austin Reeves to LBJ.
Absolutely. That's always the biggest thing. Long lead. AD's there again. Ready, available, and dunking. You've got James Davis, Russell, Rui Hachimura, and Austin Reeves. Same five that started the game. Spin! LeBron! Backhand layup's good. James, with Zach Collins in front of him, pull up for LBJ, got it, yes sir. Keep AD away from the basketball, Sohan, Collins, take it away. LeBron with a chance for the break, here comes Torian all the way, and a good pass by James.
When the Lakers are at their best, active hand, defense to offense, out on the sprint break by TP.
Still have 10 to shoot. So LeBron, the bounce. Unselfish! Throw it down, AD! Unselfish by.
Game long. Well, that's not impossible. Or that's impossible. It's a team game. But the ball movement, the sharing, the assist. The
basketball. High school in Akron, Ohio. LeBron James, boy, had the defender right on his back. The lob and the jam.
All started by LeBron. And then here, that 1-2 punch, you draw.
He fires one up from long. Let's hope he doesn't get well against the Lakers. AD kind of, it goes! It goes! He'll go to the line and shoot one.
Defenders make them choose who to defend. All-stars both sides. Oh,
happy to have her alongside once again, 30-26. And LeBron starts this quarter with the basketball. About 10 feet away. There's that little step back of his, and he scores with a soft touch. And go get yourself some egg rolls.
When the Hall of Famer speaks, we listen.
We listen.
I'm talking about all of us,
with
okay?
That tone of his, too. How are you going to say no?
Right?
Here's LeBron. 18-footer! First round. James shovels it right over to D'Angelo! Got it!
Feed him! Feed the beast from the left wing.
Short arm that time. Now LeBron looks around again. He's having so much fun with those look-away passes. Fresh snow! Reeves leans in. That's a shot that is very reliable for him. Not that time, however. Davis, mid-range magic. Lever for the trailer, Anthony Davis. Lakers are back up to a 56-47 lead. What a move!
Every time, but the face up here, the handles, keeps it simple. understands just that one.
Kept in. Block was by Vassell. Six to shoot. Weak side rebound and follow by Anthony Davis. You know what? At the half. Lakers starting front line shot 68%, 17 to 25. LeBron settles in for three.
Intellect and maturity, as Pop talked about before the game. He said, looking long-term, but the progression never stops. So the willingness to want to continue to learn and get better despite only... Austin Reeves here. Shift
San Antonio. Laker lead is 10. Their biggest was 14. We've only had one lead change in the game. Ring it up.
Easy dump off to Anthony Davis, and then LeBron finding his range.
AD backing in on Wembanyama. Goes over that long arm and scores. Last 15.
I was waiting for you.
Oh, for his last. Make it one for 16. AD hang in the air and score.
Strong.
Kind of an interesting play. LeBron with a strong dribble. And a little 10-footer is good. And he raises both his hands coming back.
Ending of what the team needs, what they're building. Yeah. Come off the bench.
Yeah, a lot of guys have to do that with Victor. Here's LeBron hanging in the air, drifting left. He recognizes that. But now he's one-on-one. Out on an island with Sohan and just bullies his way in for two more. Timeout. Here's Reeves. LeBron holds on to it over Wembanyama. Made it look oh so easy.
Celebrating his 28th birthday today. Hands off to Austin Reeves. His three-pointer off the mark. Gets his own rebound. Goes back up. There's Victor to greet him at the rim.
Hello. Victor, he's never out of a play. I mean, Austin Reeves thinks that's an easy one. That one simply...
12 rebounds.
Oh, boy, he was open.
Victor pulls the trigger for three. Got it. Victor Wembanyama. Boy, he has been on a tear. 14th made three, shooting at 41%. Comes away with another steal. Lead pass intended for Sohan. Tipped by LeBron, but right to Julian Champagny.
How about that? And yeah, Victor's staying tight to Anthony Davis. That allowed Austin Reeves to get all the way to the rim.
Clean look for Victor for three. Got it again. Wembanyama, two for two from downtown. And spotlight in L.A. trying to get this Lakers team back in gear. Champagny for three. He hits the deck. No whistle. There's Victor Wembanyama cleaning up the mess. Last night in Sacramento. There's Victor coming away with another steal. Long lead pass. Malachi Branham. Into the paint, into the body of Dinwiddie, and he gets the roll.
I thought Malachi might elect. I mean, that's unheard of. Here he is previously giving it up to Malachi Branham. I thought Malachi might pull up there, impose his will in the paint, but then Victor coming back.
Already, he's got three steals, Sean, two blocks.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
He's played 7 minutes, and he's got an and one coming up to try to make it 16 points.
Hello. And he beats cross up a point guard. And back in the day, point guards would lick their chops at a 7-footer dribbling the ball in front of him.
Wembanyama defended by Jackson Hayes, the former UT Longhorn. Nice pass. Malachi Branham softly glides it in.
Yep, he forces the double team. Here's Victor again. He pretty much has three guys around him. Spencer Dinwiddie's coming to shut off the baseline, so you know that you have a number. At that point, you just have to push.
Dinwiddie's strong, but at 6'5", not much he can do there. Blake Wesley over LeBron James for three. We're going to call it a
guy's shots on the perimeter.
Dinwiddie with a miss from downtown. Wembanyama hands it back off Jeremy Sohan. He had to get tricky inside and is able to... Austin Reeves just had it taken out of his hands by Trey Jones. Running the floor, Jeremy lobs it up. Victor throws it down.
Yeah, that's what the fans came to see. There's the alley-oop, and Jeremy Sohan read that one perfectly. Just throw it up there. Victor out running the floor, out running the field.
Spurs' chance to get a little bit closer. Nice pass from Victor, and Jeremy Sohan with a flush.
Fitting.
The largest lead in this game was 14.
Wembanyama in the paint. Spots Sochan, makes the move, and Jeremy throws it down again for the third time in the half.
The Victor show continues. Beautiful pass underneath Jeremy Sochan with an
assist. He's been averaging 7 assists over his last 5 games. Another beautiful dive from Victor Wembanyama as Trey Jones with a finish.
Huge dunk. And it was a no look to Trey Jones, who used the rim. And
Victor, crossover on Anthony Davis for 3. Got it! Victor Wembanyama, the Ooze and Oz once again from the...
Sacramento doesn't have the shot blockers.
Victor deflects another one. Gets it right back from Jeremy. What a pass into the corner. Trey for Trey. Trey Jones with his 2nd 3 of the game.
It's like, hey, I know you're a good defender. You're tough, but I am who I am. Oh, how about that?
Nice take by Victor Wembanyama, and he'll earn himself an AM1 opportunity.
Nice cross over there. Doesn't put it back in his right hand. Beautiful lefty scoop. There's a big scoop of Creamy Creations right there.
It's a big scoop.
Sweet.
Reeves, 7 to shoot. That's blocked by Victor. Austin Reeves attacking. Victor gets that one. He did. The block for Victor Wembanyama. And Keldon Johnson with the AM1 at the other end. So Victor Wembanyama with the first 5-by-5 game in the NBA since Jusuf Nurkic, January 1st of 2019.
Sideline out of bounds, Minnesota basketball. Here's Edwards. Off the flare, Cat. This one comes off to Gobert. And another opportunity for Minnesota. Edwards looked to pass it. He had an open lane to the bucket. Here's Karl-Anthony Towns again. Sidestep 3. Tipped up and controlled by Crowder. And stolen by Kyle Anderson. Edwards from deep. And Giannis pulls that down. Boy, Edwards had a great look at it. And Giannis on the fly with those lengthy strides draws the hit.
Little routine now where he kind of does a little pantomime with the shot before actually shooting it.
Whatever it takes. Whatever it takes, and I stand by that. We, again, don't forget that 50 ball that he put on the Phoenix Suns in the NBA Finals, knocked down his free throws.
Yeah. In the clincher.
In the clincher. So, to me, it, whatever it takes in those moments, good for you.
Gobert with a nice bit of jelly at the rim. Lefty finish by the big man. He's got 12.
All right, it's a 6-point game with 3.5 minutes to go. You're at home if you're the Minnesota Timberwolves. You're in a very good spot. No need to stress. Doesn't matter what your third quarter looked like. It's about closing time.
Dame with a quick sit dribble. Drives it into the paint. Out to Lopez. Retrieves it. Tough turnaround. 3! Butter! Dame Dollar with cash!
Did I just say it's closing time? Well, if it's closing time, then you know it's also Dame time.
That was cold-blooded. Edwards at the other end raises up over Lopez and scores it. He's up to 19 on the meter. Still just a 7-point advantage for the Bucks. Giannis changes gears, threw up a wild shot and drew the foul on Karl-Anthony Towns, who's incensed at that whistle. That's
says it's empowering to hear that from Giannis face to face.
Lefty in and out dribble as Giannis knocks down both free throws to make it 105-96, 2:40 to go.
And Giannis alone is 11 for 17 from the free throw line. The Minnesota Timberwolves as a team are 8 for 13.
Wow.
Anderson out front. Good defense by Lillard on McDaniels. Towns inside, caught a body, and punched it home. He's got 22. Doc Rivers imploring his team to keep playing.
Timberwolves got the string together, 3 or 4 stops here in this last 2 minutes.
Lopez thought about it, now pulls the deep three. A little hesitation might have cost him there, Richard.
Yeah, just a little bit of rhythm. Obviously, Rudy Gobert wasn't going to get all the way out there.
There's the rhythm from Anthony Edwards. No hesitation there. Edwards with 22, and the lead is down to 4. Got crunch time minutes here. Less than 5 minutes to go, less than a 5-point lead for either team. And this is the guy the Bucks signed and traded for crunch time. Dame, Dollar, this one long, but they'll have another opportunity. With 1:30 to go, Giannis splits it and draws the foul in traffic.
26-13, this game looks completely different.
And this Minnesota's first of 7 straight on this homestand. Makes 2 in a row, he's up to 32.
This is, if we're weighing these games for the Milwaukee Bucks, this is a big game. This is a very, very big game, a mental game, an emotional game for the Minnesota Timberwolves. This is your opportunity.
Towns with the 3, and 1 and done at the offensive end for Minnesota. Lillard brings it across. The score and clock in their favor. Guarded by McDaniels. He rejects the screen. Dame inside, followed by Giannis. He was pushed and fouled. And Antetokounmpo will get a couple of free throws. Dame
looks likely not going to be blocked out. So great job by Giannis getting downhill, getting that opportunity. Got to box out.
Knocks down the 2nd. 7-point lead.
All right, Minnesota's got to go quick. Now, they got 2 timeouts, so they have a lot of options, but they got to go quick, and they got to get some scores.
And off the pin down, raises up and knocks home the 3 ball to make it a 4-point game. Still a 2-possession contest. Milwaukee with possession. McDaniels with some full-court pressure. Now Edwards picks up Giannis.
Don't want to foul here.
A little run-and-jump trap there. Giannis inside. Crowder got it home. Just in time, and a timeout by Coach Finch in Minnesota. His first field goal of the game. Crowder had surgery back on November the 14th. Missed several weeks of action as a result, but a key part for Milwaukee's hopes moving forward. Here's Gobert off the inbound. Edwards takes another 3. Made the last one. 2 in a row. So it's down to a 1-possession game.
Don't need to foul.
They tried to trap Lillard.
Don't need to foul.
Giannis is not the guy you want to have the ball in his hands.
Their coach,
free throw percentage-wise.
Bitch is screaming, no foul. They weren't communicating very well.
And the play for the stop defensively, Minnesota here. Lillard. Dame time. It's Dame time. Tap your wrist with a simple flick of the wrist. Dame Lillard in his crock pot. He's cooking. 9.2 to go. Connelly into Cat. They're trying to get it to Edwards. He's made his last 2 threes. This one comes off, and that'll pretty much do it. Lillard with the rebound. And the Milwaukee Bucks with what might prove to be a signature win on the season.
6, that's all to go in the game. Pistons have it down 109 to 105.
Got to be really good. I think the Pistons have used up any margin for error they may have had.
Simone Fontecchio back to Cade, clock at 13. Judge trying to stay in front of him. Cade spins to the lane, fires, fills it up. Man, what a pro move that was. 2-point game. Cade Cunningham strikes again. Vaccaro to fourth court against Fontecchio. 1:10 left. Orlando by 2 and with it. Franz Wagner against Cade. Backs him inside, fires from in front. Off iron. Rebound, Jalen Duren. Off to Cade.
Wonder if he's going to give it up or take it again.
Stop and go move, forces a foul.
I believe that's their first.
Suggs got him. They had that foul to give, I believe. Yep.
First in the last 2 minutes. Suggs trying to cut him off because he knows Cade Cunningham wants this. Look at this, George. How tough is this? And he's being hounded.
You're in his office, though. Do what you want to do, but you're going to have a heck of a time stopping Cade Cunningham around the paint. Clock at five. Cade back to the lane. Lobs it. Jalen Duren couldn't touch it down. Carter Jr. has the rebound. 35 seconds left.
That was too 50-50. That was too much 50-50. Even chance for Carter Jr. or Duren to get it. Probably not the play you wanted that particular second.
Shot clock down to 10 for the Magic. 20 seconds to go in the game. Vancaro to the baseline. Misses. Contact, though. Ready to shoot two with 17.9 to play. Missed the first. And now let's see what he'll do with the second free throw. Short. Rebound. Jalen Duren.
Wow.
Timeout Pistons.
That was a chance at an offensive rebound.
Got inbound the ball. No timeouts. Fournier looking. Bounces it to Cade. Screen from Jalen Duren. Cade to the basket. He hits it. What a play. Cade would not be denied. 12.4 seconds left in regulation. All even. Carroll gets the first catch. Backs up near the sideline. 6 seconds. Now five. Now four. Up fake from the baseline. Knocks it down with 8/10 of a second left. Vancaro, who was ice cold all night, just warm enough here to make a tough, tough shot.
He has all but forgotten about the two free throw misses prior. And as I said, it didn't shock me because he's probably over there, coach, please, please let me have it. And Jalen Duren made him take a tough shot. He made it, and he got fouled.
Well, for the foul is Jalen Duren.
Pistons lose this. This is a microcosm of their whole season. They've had every bad thing that could happen to them all year long. And this just adds to it.
Free throw falls. Can they somehow get a three in the air with 8/10 of a second left to force overtime?
It's going to have to come from a long way, like right here.
Cade lets it fly. Who knows? Oh!
Wow. Wow.
Hit the rim.
Improvement on the turnovers since the start of the year. Brunson guarded by Cunningham. Pull-up jump shot from Jalen Brunson. Well, the first time these two teams played, the Knicks were up by one after the first. It was tied at halftime, and they trailed after three. Oh, what a move, Brunson. He's kind of swerving across the lane and floats it up and in.
Good to see him back with the group again.
Well, Hartenstein, I'm not sure if he's still doing it every game, but after Robinson got hurt, as Brunson pulls up, hits the jumper. Brunson, Duren didn't go for the fake.
He's also one of the most physically imposing players in the league.
Oh, Brunson way outside. He's got 9 points already. Brunson, once again, three-pointer, puts it in. What a start from Brunson. The Brunson burner is lit early.
If not for him, where's the offense coming from? 12 so far now. 12 after this step-in three-pointer. And also, again, the minutes played almost 40 a game. In February, he's leading the NBA in minutes per game. Over 40 minutes per game.
On the turnover, Brunson comes the other end.
A different level, a different speed, whatever it is. Bogdanović have to play himself into a higher level of condition.
Brunson, another jumper, 14 points for Brunson. Tried to get it down to Wiseman. Saved it, but right to Burks. Into the hands of Brunson. Burks. Shot is good, and a foul. Burks felt the contact, threw it out of the rim, and a chance for a three-point play.
He takes two hits on this, but still gets the finish and the chance for a three-point play. Takes the contact, and as Wiseman comes over, clocks him right in the jaw. Right there.
Bogdanović kind of looking to see where he needs to go. Bogdanović behind the arc. Knocks down the three. But you just see the difference, yep. The poise in him.
And you would think missing all that time would cost him in development.
DiVincenzo lines it up and knocks it down, his second three-pointer. DiVincenzo, no hesitation. Sims, his fourth offensive rebound off the bench. Brunson finds room, gets inside, count it, and one. Not going to to miss that layup and a chance for a three-point play.
This was Wally Szczerbiak's matchup to watch. It has not disappointed so far. Cunningham having a great start. Look at Jalen Brunson, what he does best, the footwork, and of course, the adulation from the guard.
Thompson gets up into Brunson. Brunson back out hard. Long three-pointer. Got it! Ninth three-pointer of the first half. Brunson trying to find some space. Six on a shot clock. Finds DiVincenzo cutting. Layup. He bangs it in.
Pistons 7 of 14 in the first half before that miss.
Einstein spins. Gets inside. I don't think he wanted to shoot it. He was a whirling dervish in there. Shot clock at 7. Brunson up top. DiVincenzo. Three-pointer's good. There's the riverboat gambler. That's what Tom Thibodeau calls him. No hesitation.
Shirt tucked in, which was a very... What happens here?
This is these dangerous games when you let the team hang around. Brunson. Three-pointer's good. Jalen Brunson, his third three of the game, and he's got 23 points. It's usually the key on that, or the magic word, or continuous when you're told, knock it off. Hart, line drive, knocks down the three. Ivy played him well. Shot clock, now down to 5. Brunson cuts, floats it up and in. Hart to Brunson, 11-point lead. Two at double figures and boards again. Bogdanović runs into Fournier. They say play on, and Bogdanović knocks down the shot. He's got 10. Cunningham. Cross-court stolen by DiVincenzo. Ahead to Brunson. Brunson drives. Back out DiVincenzo. Three-pointer. Bang!
These guys are incredible. Just know where each other are on the floor and nowhere to go.
That's the 11th assist for Brunson. Fifth time this year he's in 10 assists or more. Grimes jump shot. Back in the rim won't go, but Durin right there. Bogdanović had his hands on the ball, but Durin's strength. Brunson looking. His three-pointer. Shot no good. Tipped out Bogdanović. Back to Hart. Hart has it knocked away. And a foul. That's going to be the fourth team foul. Brunson. Achua drives inside. A lot of contact there. Shot no good. Kept alive. Taken by Grimes. Under 4 to play. Fontecchio to Cunningham. Thought about the three. Thompson goes inside. Hartenstein closes. Grimes, three-pointers up. Shot's good. Quentin Grimes gives the Pistons their first lead since the first quarter.
He gives the Nick bench a glare as he runs down the floor. Remember me?
He's got 12 points, all of them here in the fourth. 3.5 to go. Six to shoot. Hart gets inside. The floater's up. Shot no good. Rebound. Achua lays it up and in. We're tied.
Achua comes in the game as Tom Thibodeau saw the Knicks playing small. Not a good matchup. He went big. Achua and Hartenstein in the game together.
Fourth offensive rebound for Achua. 11th total. 3 minutes to play. Cunningham gets inside. Shot put, won't go. DiVincenzo the rebound ahead to Brunson. Brunson drives inside, stops, hesitates, and puts it in. He's got 32 tonight. Gets away from DiVincenzo. Steps up, jump shot. Won't go. Hart the rebound.
Cunningham suddenly cold, not making his shots, frustrated with himself.
Brunson the hesitation, jump shot, puts it in. 35 for Brunson. Knicks back up by 4. Grimes calling out a play, asking for a screen. DiVincenzo shuts him off. Grimes gets it back. Up top to Cunningham. Kicks it out in the corner. Thompson a 3. That's good. How about the rookie Thompson from downtown shooting 15% from that distance this season?
15% means some of them go in. That one, timely.
Knicks lead by 1. Under two to play. Thompson guarding Brunson. Brunson a three-pointer. And grinds the rebound. Anxious moments here. You can feel the anxiety from the crowd. Minute and a half remaining. Cunningham guarded by Hart. Gets away, lobs it up to Durant, blocked! A chill on Hartenstein, meet him at the rim! What a defensive play!
That was incredible.
Shot clock at five. Jalen Brunson on the drive. Kicks it back out to Hart. Hart, foul line jumper. In and out. Hartenstein battling, knocked out of bounds. Pistons ball. Cunningham being chased. Up top, Fontecchio. Extra pass to Grimes. Shot clock at six. Grimes off the bounce. Running layup is good. What a shot from Grimes. 14 points here in the fourth quarter. And the Pistons lead by one. Brunson looking. Guarded by Cunningham. Fontecchio looking to help. Brunson, three-pointer, off the mark, rebound deflected, chased down, saved by Grimes to Fontecchio, knocked away, Hartenstein picks it up, out to DiVincenzo, 10 seconds to go, he throws it away, ball loose, picked up by Brunson, Brunson inside to Hart, Hart banks it in, and a foul! Knicks take the lead, Monty Williams is furious, he thought a foul should have been called, there was so much contact. Josh Hart with the big bucket and a free throw coming up.
It's a missed three-pointer. It's a battle for a rebound. The hustle by Grimes. They should have the ball. Tipped away by Hart. Not giving it up on it. Hartenstein. DiVincenzo looking again for Brunson. A steal by Thompson. Look at the hustle by DiVincenzo. Diving for what seemed to be a loose ball that was right in front of us.
Hart misses the free throw. Saved by Hart. And a whistle and a foul. I think it's before the shot attempt. Won't matter because it's...
Brunson under control, just finding Josh Hart with seconds left for the finish, the contact, the and one.
Hart knocks that one down. Tied a season high, 23 points. Monty Williams is furious, and he may have had a case that there was so much contact when Thompson lost the ball, but the Knicks stayed with the play. Brunson able to pick it up and find the assist to Josh Hart. And this one's huge, obviously, to make it a three-point game. Hart misses another ball, batted loose. Hart picks it up, the game's over. The Knicks win. What a wild, wild ending.
Golden State Warriors coming off a win against Charlotte a couple of nights ago. Curry and the rest of the starters did not play a lot of minutes as Joker wheels for the bucket.
Teaming up with Klay Thompson, Jonesy.
Yeah, they're starting to peak at the right time and play their best basketball at just the right time, becoming whole. Jokic on the turnaround knocks it home.
I think it's great when Klay Thompson can get a touch early in possessions. They've run him off of off-ball screens multiple times down the floor now. Gets a high percentage look.
Porter Jr. laces that three ball. Porter Jr. No help for Kuminga defensively. No double team. Porter Jr. on the bounce. Left it short. And Jokic cleans it up. We're tied at 17. Joker with six. Joker at the elbow. He leads the NBA in elbow touches. Boy, what a spin move. You need a GPS to find him.
I mean, this is just a heck of a move. He sets it up. Well, no one wants to be patient, right? And allow teams to build chemistry, build camaraderie, figure out roles.
Clippers are the number three seed in the Western Conference. Denver right behind them, the four seed.
Got the ball to Wiggins in a position to be successful. Gave him the space to operate.
What a great connector. In the words of head coach Steve Kerr, Watson knocks down the baseline three. He's got nine. Great balance early in the ballgame by the Warriors. Jokic with the finger roll. Wiggins touches the paint. Floater off the mark. Jokic with a nice outlet to KCP. Oh. Runs the floor, counted, and one. The look here, Stephanie.
These are those long outlet passes. The ability to explode out, head up.
Thompson guarded by Murray. You can allow him that kind of heat check,
you
right,
can.
Coach?
You absolutely can.
Murray for three, and how Jamal Murray?
Still up by 12.
Joker on the pick and pop. Got it. Remember, it was that 39-footer at the buzzer that won the last meeting. Nuggets in the middle of a 9-0 run. Quick post-up and rim run by Gordon. And one! So Aaron Gordon with a chance to make it a 2-point contest. Out top here to Joker. Murray for three. Got it! Jamal Murray. Porter Jr. off the curl. Back to Jokic. Tries one from outside that caroms off to Gordon. Back to Joker, who lays it home. Joker sprays it out to Caldwell Pope. Kuminga one-on-one against Jokic. Light work for Nikola Jokic. Misfires on the layup. Denver up by two on the move. They got a 5-on-4. Murray pulls. Butter. And a quick timeout by Steve Kerr. Wiggins partially blocked by Murray. Jokic with the outlet to Caldwell Pope. Pulls the three. Got it.
Well, we've seen it time and time again. Jokic, all he does is turn. Leads it up the floor. And KCP finding that stroke.
Raised the level of his play to perhaps get into a little bit of the MVP conversation as well. Jokic inside. Big body bends move. Joker with the jump hook.
How he can free himself up, and you've seen him get a couple of buckets, get to the free throw line a little bit here in the third quarter, and then defensively, the stress from the coaching staff was make sure that they defend in transition, Jonesy.
Jokic guarded by Looney. Jackson for three, and he laces that one. Thompson for three. That's about the easiest look he's had. Brown in transition. Boy, Kuminga climbed the ladder but couldn't get to it. Curry leads the league in clutch time scoring. Great read defensively by Joker to make the interception and the lob to Najee against Denver. Look at the anticipation here.
Yeah, heads up play. Great read by Jokic. And then how about this? The subtlety, the pass fake.
Green inside and it comes off. Everything but the bucket for Golden State. Caldwell Pope for three. Got it.
In transition, Caldwell Pope. Nobody steps up. Continuing to climb in the standings. You got an opportunity at home where you played so well.
Jokic inside with a scoop shot.
I mean, again, you look at the movement. Jokic understands where he is on the floor.
10-point lead for Denver. Jokic at the elbow, hands it back to Murray. There's that two-man game that is so difficult to stop. They switch back. Pocket pass to Jokic. Porter Jr. raises up on the midi. And Jokic tips it home. They double-team Murray, the lob, and out of the dunker spot. Aaron Gordon.
His favorite target, Jokic to Gordon, slams it home.
Bounces off of Holmgren and leaves that fadeaway short. Here's Shea again, working his way to the cup, goes with the left hand, bouncing off bodies.
Rockets are setting a lot of high ball screens out in front.
Oh, what a contest at the rim, Chet Holmgren. Oh, what a contest at the rim, Chet Holmgren. Not allowing the dive from Thompson. And Thompson can get up there. He is athletic, and Shea takes a little bump and able to play through it, plus the foul.
And that's terrific, as you just said, what, six seasons?
Chet Holmgren brings the Thunder a little bit closer. This late second quarter run. 16-0. You don't see that very often.
No, not at all. And here's a chance here for a fast break opportunity. As the Rockets get the numbers back. Skip pass by Josh, and a delivery by Chet outside over the next, several decades, if not more, as that guy we're talking about with a bucket. I mean, it's just impacting people's lives for generations.
Those things go a long ways. And Chet Holmgren with another smothering block, this time on Green. A couple of possessions with some points, but SGA attacking again. Kept that pivot foot down. Everybody clears out, and he's got the layup.
And he just waited for air traffic to clear.
Fell, but that time on the defensive end. Now a mismatch. Shea came on the backside and knocked it away.
That's great weak side help by him.
Shea spinning, bouncing off the defenders on the left side and banks it home. Green, 37 years old. What a crossover. SGA got to the rim. SGA scores. What a beauty on the drive. Rockets open it. He turns into the player. He's drafted number three back in 2022. Shea leans in and goes glass. Quarter. No reasons why to play great defense. Shutting down the fast break opportunities for the Rockets. And right out of the gate here in the fourth quarter as he still laid them up. Another block for Chet Holmgren. Hayward, off-balance shot, offensive rebound. Holmgren's put back. That's going to drop in. His ability to block shots, and he has just been so reliable on both ends. Getting smarter by the game. Giddey is trying a fast break opportunity. No on the runner, but there is Holmgren with the follow.
The bench players for the Rockets have been pretty solid up until that point. And all of a sudden, the Thunder bench came to life along with Chet to get them started.
Those threes start to flatten out a little bit as we come up on the five-minute mark. Shea probing. J-Dub's got a little bit of space, and J-Dub's got himself a three. There is Holmgren. Little flyby. Back outside, SGA spots up for the three and splashes it home. In the NBA from three-point land at over 39%.
And how about this? The Thunder have won in this building, what, in the last couple of years? And Shea is just going to put a cherry on top.
Because that says a lot about the individuals. It says a lot about Darko Rajakovic, the head coach, Kyrie's on the board. Because
as Toronto turns it over.
Yeah, Barnes throws away the wraparound bounce pass. Here's Kyrie on the dance floor. Over two defenders, he nails it. A beer can flowed into my peripherals last night, and it was really nice, I have to admit. I finished in about 5 minutes, which is a record
for me. I heard the whole conversation, and it reminded me of what you just talked about. Great find.
Yeah.
Well, you're going to see him because Luka's a genius at finding open players.
He's doing so many of the right things, sharing the ball, yeah. The right passes, hard-nosed defense. You know the shot's going to start to fall. Here's a zigzag drive through the defense and the 25-year-old legs of Luka Doncic.
Get a license now or something. You said.
Yeah, he can rent a car now.
Rent a car. There you go.
Luka finds Gafford to the screen and roll. The number one field goal percentage player in the NBA.
Second shots always tend to hurt you.
Luka fouled and one.
Here's a look at it. There's the reach and there's Luka's head right up to the basket. Spectacular touch that time.
Who came over from the Utah Jazz, misses on the corner, three-point heat.
He's played well here with Toronto, though. Look at that pass.
It is a sweet pass, and it's a big hit from the corner. Luka going out, Kai coming back into Hart's point, well, but here's that pass.
Yeah, you know, some guys have more eyes than others. Obviously, Luka seeing a wide open Tim Hardaway Jr. You know, you got
That would have given the Raptors the lead again. There have been seven ties and three lead changes in the opening quarter of this game. Lob finish, lively from Luka.
You can change some shots down there. And offense looking over its back when there's a presence there.
For three, Luka, yes sir. Mavericks had a 15-point burst at the end of the half where Luka scored 14 of the 15 points. 12 of the 14 were on a barrage of threes.
Luka's going to get you now or later.
Abaji fouled and then he makes the jump shot. A chance for three the old-fashioned way. A 22-foot jump shot here for the and one.
Well, that's what MVP-type players do. They find a way to manipulate you. And Luka Doncic. A lot of defenses because of his size.
Here's Kyrie. measuring Scotty Barnes, speaking of having to deal with a long defender. Late clock situation, and it's off. Late, it appeared. It goes in. It off in time. I can't tell from that angle. There we go. In his appearance.
I'm going to have to talk to you a little bit more about Bad Bunny and those guys. Nice pass.
Luka loving and soaring Daniel Gafford, a basket shaker.
Beautiful timing on that pick and roll. And Gafford went upstairs here on the road.
First possession was good defense. Challenge shot by R.J. Barrett, rebounded by Lively. And then Lively, a catch in the paint, and a turn, and a slam.
He's got to stay connected, and there's a lot of basketball to play.
Kyrie with a stare-down three, a rainbow over Barnes. Luka, driving kick. Green moves it. Kyrie sidesteps quickly. Oh, great passing, and it leads to another basket shaker for Lively. Lively wedged himself in there. Now Luka finds Kai. And Kyrie leaves his feet. Hello, Wenda. Hello, three-point play opportunity. Yes. Three-point Mavs lead in the third. Luka. And he shoots from the baseline. It was a long count, but the five-second call.
Trent Jr. was left out to dry, basically.
That is so true. That is a tough place. Dan found the ball. Oh, Luka. Oh, happy birthday. He's got four made threes, so Green is not going to give him any airspace at the three-point line, and his runner is missed.
The pass.
Over the top, P.J. Washington caught it. End of the floor, and then, you know, a big part of the Mavericks' up-tempo this year. They had Hardaway missing badly, and Grady Dick misses badly at the other end of the floor as well.
Luka,
trying to carve up Olynyk on the baseline drive, and he scores inside. 20 points, 13 assists, quickly in and out on a three.
Look at this pass.
Now that's another long pass up to Gafford! For Dallas to extend this to a double-digit lead.
Oh, that's awesome. Of a chance, and you have more argument for his MVP.
Inside again, reaching into the bag of tricks.
Yeah.
Nikola Jokic did it a couple of years ago as well. Here's a rebound for Exum, and another pass, and Luka's going to get the cherry pick here and finish 186. Exum has 4 points tonight in his return to play after missing the last 13 games. Kyrie into the paint on the money. I think the jump shot's going to come for him. He doesn't look like he's uncomfortable taking it.
No, he's not uncomfortable, but two different things.
Oh, explosive thrust to the basket again by Kyrie Irving.
And he's fundamentally sound. You know, anytime you spend time in San Antonio, going to have his fundamentals down.
Oh, that's a nice part of having Exum back into the picture. Up 12. Kyrie. Don't have to ask him. Don't have to tell him to continue to play.
I think all players get down on themselves at that. But I worry about a lot. I don't worry about Tim Hardaway Jr. because I know sooner or later as Kyrie knocks down the three.
Never worry about him either. He was playing pretty darn good in New York and playing even better here in Toronto. Kyrie Irving, fourth quarter, is that man's time. There's still work to do with 4.5 minutes left in the game. 122 to 110 Dallas. Hard drive, tough shots. What an acrobatic finish. Luka, tough defense by Olynyk, really crowded him after he picked up the dribble. Found an outlet in Washington. Back to Doncic. Fade away. Foul as well.
You know, the special thing about that, he knew exactly where the clock was.
Knocking down the three. Luka down the baseline, deflection. Green out, leaps quickly for the ball. Finds Washington. PJ misses. Ball falls right to Luka.
Nah, that's not a coincidence. There's a miss.
And this is a guy that averages 22 a contest. Mid-range, Brandon Ingram. Back at it. Brandon losing his footing. Bam. Another mid-range. Okay.
You can get to wherever you want to get to. Weak side of the floor.
Pels have started the game 9 for 10 on the fall away. How to step through instead. Beautiful work by Brandon Ingram. Great footwork.
He's right in front of us, and he's telling Jonas, go to work on him. Go to work on Miles Turner.
Jonas clearing it out. You got a 5-on-4, basically. Z shares it. Brandon launching. Got the triple.
Beautiful offense. Beautiful offense.
Little step through. And then what about beyond the arc?
Love it. Go to work.
Brandon
go to work.
Up against Halliburton.
Go to work.
A little longer than knees been. Here comes the double. Fall away. Tough shot.
Boy, B.I. on one right now, Joe. He on one right now. When he becomes a three-level scorer, it's game over. It's game over. He didn't even get a lather. He just came in and let that joint go.
Brandon all the way to the hole.
Boy, he cooked it.
And another timeout for Rick Carlisle. Now I said you while we were away, AD. The really amazing part of it all is Larry Nance Jr. into the game for the first time. Brandon, that was a reach by Siakam. He'll take it anyway.
Boy, you out here killing. You out here killing, B.I. There's a pop or a bop in B.I.'s step when he gets going, right? That pop is here now.
Nice, about to check in. Brandon going to the hole again. He just went.
You saw that coming. The Pacers have 16 points.
Oh, yeah.
I tell you,
it's going to be really good.
This B.I. is special.
Jose waiting. He wants Brandon.
Raise
good
up.
Reason.
Raise up.
He's got Mathurin on.
Raise up.
Big advantage size-wise. And the fall away.
Yep. Yes! Raise up. You saw
amazing. He's not a shooter. We saw the three, and it was real strong. Brandon. And Jose. Gets the layup. Brandon back on the floor. Up against Obi Toppin. Set the pick for Trey. Good look.
Oh, got welcome it back. Again. Welcome back, Trigger.
You said it.
Welcome back, Trigger. You got to be even 5'10". Look, miscommunication.
Pels haven't scored for better than 5 minutes. Nice pass. Larry got the layup.
That's it. You have to close the ball in number 14's hand.
And company assist of the night so far.
Again, you take two with you. Now you've done your job. Now you just got to trust your teammates to finish. Off this dribble handoff. It's a great read by Brandon Ingram. Good roll by Larry Nance.
You got a zone here. Oh, they missed Siakam. Wide open underneath. And it's
that's a great away. Play by Herb. That's a great play by Herb Jones.
Brandon coming up. Doesn't have the numbers. It'll be CJ for three. Got it! 2 minutes remaining in the half. Pell still shooting 64%. Mid-range, Brandon. Yeah. It's still there.
You have to find the hot hand and ride that hot hand.
Dort, and Brandon's got it. Boy, that went up early. Trey running. Three ball.
Yes! Speaking of going up early, Joe.
Man, Brandon now with Trey.
He wanted that matchup right there. Great pass.
Set it up beautifully. Trey.
Bang!
What a way to finish an incredible first half.
And trust his ability to make plays. That is an excellent read by Brandon Ingram. I've taken two with me. I've done my job.
So both teams struggling right now at the offensive end. The only bucket for the Pels, CJ's triple. And a nice crossover. Brandon on the reverse. Going to the line. Incredible.
Claude have mercy.
How did that come home?
Oh, my. I'm all in favor, Joe, of this. What it is Willie put his best two players in action.
You don't have numbers. 3 minutes gone by as he sizes things up.
Put your two best players in action.
And he did.
Yep.
Mid-range.
Brandon Ingram. Put your two best players in action. Maybe that is the definition of a high-low. So that's back-to-back plays, right? You put B.I. and Zion in a step-up screen situation. Last time B.I. got the switch, got an opportunity to turn the corner.
Brandon, by the way, we talked about at the top of the telecast his efficiency in Indiana. Mid-range, step through.
Throw it off the glass to yourself. Yes! Throw it off the glass to yourself.
Why not? Everything else has worked.
It is all about Brandon Ingram tonight. Throw it off the glass and go get it.
Giannis going to walk down and spin. Sends it with his chest. And the Bucks lead by 5. It's been a top 5 defense in the last several games. Great kick out by Giannis to Lopez. And Lopez drains his second three ball. It's a 7-point lead. And the Bulls have cut the Milwaukee lead to two. Giannis made 2 3-pointers against Charlotte. And he's in a nice little rhythm right now. Lillard out top. It's Giannis on the short roll. There's that pick and roll game that a lot of people have been calling for more of. Off to Beverly. Bucks on the run. Giannis knifing through the lane for the lefty lay. He's got 15. What do you do about this? Besides maybe get a restraining order.
Hey, I don't think you're going to get any.
To page number one on the scouting report.
Yeah, I mean, what Coby White has done this year in terms of his improvement, his usage rate is off the charts, his minutes are off the charts. He's gone from third or fourth on the scouting report.
Crowder reverses one more to the corner. Beverly drives it inside to Giannis, and he punches it home.
Good things happen when the ball gets moving, and Pat Bev draws multiple defenders. There is nothing you can do about this, Mark.
Giannis rejects the screen, got downhill, and lays it home.
I mean, you just can't do anything about that. He's been getting to his spots. He's been taking his post-ups.
11-point lead. Lillard lays it up, lobs it up for Antetokounmpo. There's
defensively, right here, Vucevic doesn't expect the help, and it comes. There's no rotation. You got to at least have Brook Lopez feel you. I mean, this is what he does, right? Yeah. He knocks down three-point shots.
Giannis had the ball knocked loose.
Using each other, making the extra pass.
Beasley on the baseline. Giannis, great ball movement, Stephanie.
No defense for that. And that's exactly what this team had been missing. Somebody who is vocal
right. In
communicating at all times, like a coach on the floor.
Well, he gassed him up for the layup right there. It works, Stephanie. They empty out the side for Giannis to work against Drummond. Giannis playing with his food, takes the midi. Cash. If he starts making that
right?
with consistency, it's over. Giannis will walk it across. Under 6 minutes to go here in the third. Milwaukee in control. In rhythm, Giannis laces the three ball. Those are great looks for him, right?
They're great looks. And you got Brook Lopez that's popping, so if you drag out the D.
Oh, Giannis standing on business with a punch on the baseline.
I mean, this guy, just the spin off of Drum.
Lopez flipped the angle to the ball screen that time. A little pick and pop. Giannis with the offensive rebound and some room service. Here's Lillard off the drag set by Giannis. Lillard raises up. Tipped out to the corner. Beasley right back to Giannis inside. Room service.
8-4 advantage for Brooklyn. Towns with the handle. Penetrating inside and getting the easy layup.
He stopped complaining and got back in transition and contested that corner three.
Edwards got Simmons in the air, penetrates and lays it in. 38 to go in the opening frame. Beautiful finish. Bridges short on a tray. Anderson the rebound, quickly ahead. Towns scores. No whistle. And a tough bucket by Towns. Back in a moment.
They've got to be up there at the point of attack, too, depending upon who's shooting the basketball or using the ball screen.
Towns for three. Bottoms. Smith on the attack. Swatted by Reed. Edwards penetrating. Off glass. And the Wolves close the quarter on an 11-0 run. Battle for the board. Sharp blocked outside to Edwards. Edwards, Euro, and the lefty finish. Wolves on top. 6 points, Towns with 9. Wolves by 1 headed into the second.
It's not that it wasn't a travel, it certainly was.
Towns, oh, the hammer over Claxton.
Get Carl Anthony Towns. The one-hand package of dynamite right there. He detonates that thing. That was surprising.
Oh, go-go Bridget
on. Right on Nick Claxton's head.
Wolves down two. Edwards splitting the defense. Finishes with the left. Towns. Crossover. Step back. Got another.
Nikhil's at the scoring table. I think he's coming in for Jaden as Ant rattles one in.
3-pointer from Edwards. Wolves on top. That pass broken up and stolen. 2-on-2 fast break. Edwards lays it up and in. Towns for three. Boom!
He's been the one guy that's been able to make shots. He hits this hedge out by Karl Anthony Towns, but again, designed three-point shot.
Towns has 24. Backing down Claxton, lefty hook rolls through.
It's like the game in Brooklyn. Then using his arms wisely there, creates some space.
Second night of a back-to-back for Minnesota. Edwards, step back, three ball, cash!
Big time. Carl Anthony Towns has been excellent, but Anthony Edwards right there, letting foot's on the line.
Got a streak going of games going over 100. Edwards to the rim! Off the feed from slow-mo.
Good cut that time by Ant. Throws it home with two hands. Last time Minnesota didn't score 100 points in a game was at Brooklyn, by the way. They scored 96 that night.
Edwards feeling bouncy. Oh, beautifully done.
Jaden has been a little more aggressive here. Again, as you said, nice way right now, trying to shake it off.
Edwards, Euro, flips it up. Oh, bucket and the foul.
That's phenomenal. Anthony Edwards, impossible shot, just a circus shot, and then gives a fan a little hand slap after he spins around. That was awesome.
We have some serious NFL talent in the building. Joe Burrow, Ja'Marr Chase, Cincinnati's incredible quarterback receiver duo, and Odell Beckham Jr. in the building as well.
Yeah, spring.
10-5, Hawks. Bridges, the low dribble. Over Bay, count it. 8-0 run for the Hawks. Smith had 10 points, 5 assists the other night. Feed it. Bridges, got a 3. There's Bridges. Fires and hits a 3.
No, you're not going to get up close, though.
Yep.
Yeah, I mean, great times, great memories. I mean, I played with some, obviously, great point guard, great teammates and players. So.
Mikal Bridges put it on the board. It's a 3. Nets are up to 7 of 16 from three-point territory. That's 44%. Hawks are down to 7 of 17 from 3, 41%. Bridges, nicely done. Bridges. Schroeder, drive and kick for Smith, who's back in. Bridges takes it strong and finishes. Bridges, quick jack. Got it! On a 2-for-1, Mikal Bridges catches it.
He got his left arm.
Correct.
This was the Bridges 3, and you mentioned the ice tray. Yeah. That's cold. Bridges' jumper, he's got it.
See there, Bridges checking to see exactly where Sadiq Bey is. Oh, he's out of the play. Great job by Claxton rolling. Not allowed him to get back.
Capella couldn't finish it. Bogdanovich is there. That won't go. Long rebound, Bridges. Now it's a race to the rim. Bridges is going to win the race and lay it in.
His jump shot. Now you see here, Bridges in the transition. I'm going to outrun you, then I'm going to get in front of you so you cannot block my shot.
8:42 to go in the third. Bridges, drive, corkscrews in.
Great job.
For the bucket.
There's the swing through, gets it to the middle. Step through, finish. The Brooklyn.
A Bogdanović using the screen, sweeping move, denied by Claxton. Bridges glides in for two.
And it's just great, great job of not fouling there again by Schroeder, allowing your shot blockers to do the job, which leads to an easy basket.
Ball deflected into the hands of Bridges. Nets are running. Bridges looking for the angle. He's got it! On the fly, Mikal Bridges.
You see it here. There's a steal. If you look right now, Deron is holding up traffic.
Claxton with a double-double. 10 points, 12 rebounds. Bridges. The jumper goes. Bingo. Plus one.
Let's see here.
Bay got him on the arm.
Let's see here.
Bay got him on the arm.
Let's see here. Yeah, this is better. Ooh.
Felt like it was after the release.
I think Bridges was trying to force his way through a little window.
Steal.
That's how you get it back right there.
Bridges to the rim. Mikal Bridges. No toll. Robinson runs past Markkanen with four on the shot clock. It's Butler. Steps back on Collins. Kaboom. Sexton. Oh, he's quick. But he missed it. Here comes Bam. The Heat have numbers. Three on one. Rozier for Jimmy. He converted over the 7-foot Lauri Markkanen.
Really smart group of young folks going to that school. Excellent opportunity for Miami here in the bonus.
21 and a half points per game. He has turned the corner towards his best basketball of the season as we get closer and closer.
The kid pictures with the guys, it's always fun.
Wharton Tucker making some veteran plays for them. Jimmy out of the corner for three. Kaboom! Butler driving in. Changing hand. Hendricks blocked it. Butler powered it in. Boy, he had to outlast Taylor Hendricks and the Utah defense. 10 points for Duncan. Duncan with the steal. Oh, Bam did not know it was coming. Collided with Hendricks. Both men are down, and Butler gets a layup.
From beyond the arc.
Robinson, bullets for Jovic. Into the corner, Jimmy for the triple. Got it! Jimmy Butler has tripled for the third time in this game. He with just 5 free throw attempts today. They've all come from Jimmy. And John, I think the concern for Miami, we talked about it, a failure to consistently win at home. Miami trailing by 6 with 5:40 left, third quarter. Rozier. Oh, to Butler. He's only played 11 minutes. Oh, Jovic knocking it away from Collins, leading to this. Butler, two pump fakes, and a chance at a three-point play the Butler way.
Right, that's better than a crazy Andy deal.
Three shots, three pump fakes, and a three-point play for Jimmy Butler.
He's really looking for Jimmy Butler right now, who's in a great role on the offensive end. Excellent post-up and deep penetration there.
To the bench. Well, Jimmy Butler having one of his biggest offensive games of the year. 28 points for him. And
see now Butler there with the layup and it rolls in. Jimmy Butler just doing what he does best. Inside, gets the bucket.
That was his third triple of the game. Jimmy, he wants two back. I gotta get three back. Tell you what you want to do against Utah. Keep them under 120 points. When they get to 120, their chances of winning rise dramatically. Jimmy, baseline jumper for Butler. Gets it back from Bam with 8 on the shot clock. It's Butler's turn. Back to Terry. Jimmy, quick first step, got fouled and scored. Finishing touch.
The weather is just gorgeous here in Memphis today. That brings a lot of people out as well. Simons outside, triggers, and scores on a three. Anthony Simons. Blazers snapping a 9-game losing streak last night. How sweet that was indeed.
The tech was on him too?
Yep.
So after flopping, he was trying to pressure Anthony on the inbounds. So there might be a time where he's got to mix it up.
Hurt gets into the lane on a nice lead pass. Conchar steals the inbounds, but saves right to Higgins in full stride.
5-on-3.
Scoops to Simons for three. Down the hatch.
You might think, all right, we can get over on this dude. Okay, Ant. Okay, I didn't know if he was going to rise up all the way. He went with the simple.
Simons trying to shake one of the Williams.
Oh.
Well, Jackson's got that ability, doesn't he? Man. Soars to the rim. Simons comes back the other way.
Wow.
Gets contact with Hurt and scores on the run. Team tonight came in averaging.
The Sling. That's a good name for his shot.
That's Sling, man. Yeah. Simons. He just pops one in there on a rope. Higgins and Simons working with just under 8 minutes remaining. Simons, tough shot, fading away, cash it in.
Once again, they're not able to get it to them the way they want, so Ashton's trying to make a play.
He pivots, coming to it. Kamara, four to shoot. Nice cut and a beautiful pass on a dime. Zaire Williams, watch it. Simons, they try to spring him off a Walker pick. The 6'11 Aldama closes out, but Simons triggers over him and scores.
Wow.
With the Blazers trailing here by 5 and 3:56 remaining. Simons, 26 tonight. Blazers playing shorthanded. Memphis obviously shorthanded. They got two fresh guys from. Was sitting last night, Conchar and Kennard. Blazers playing this entire second half without Grant. Simons waiting for Walker to screen. Now they switch it with Aldama on him. Simons figures to take him off the bounce. He'll pull up and swish one from the elbow.
And Suns, these two teams have spent a lot of time at the foul line against one another this season, averaging a combined almost 62 free throw attempts over the course of the three matchups. Deflected by Van Vliet, picked up by Green, one on two, splits the seam, gets to the rim, and lays it up and in. But it still goes down as a turnover. Now Durant again, two bodies on him. As soon as he catches the ball, forces another turnover. Green from Brooks by himself. Hey! How about that?
Showtime here. Jalen Green on the break. Full extension on the windmill. The Dunkstronaut with the Academy Sports and Outdoor Super Bowl replay.
Their first 7 years with Portland, now here with the Suns. A little loose handle there for Green. Able to track it back down, but the Rockets now playing deep into the shot clock. Van Vliet to Şengün. Back to a wide open Green. Straightaway three is good. Two on Şengün. Passes it back out on the reset to Jalen Green. Working on O'Neal. Makes the three over the top of Royce O'Neal. Another one. He's got 14. As he tried to split two defenders. Allen to the rim. No whistle there. Follow go. Also go, no good by
Take
Durant.
Advantage.
The Suns have two guys down. They only have three defenders.
Go.
The
Run.
Rockets are playing with a two-man advantage, and Green will shoot the three, and he will make it.
That's what the zone wants. Drive it. Attack it.
Drives in a two-handed volleyball spike there by Alperen Şengün. Back to Green, he'll fire it up to three. Good, at both ends of the floor, outpeed defensively. Jalen Green sticks another triple. Another one? Yes, another one for Jalen Green. He likes shooting the rock against the Suns. Threes, he's got 23. Good look at stroke there on the.
Got to attack. Yes, attack this zone. Don't
into
settle.
Into Şengün right in the middle of the defense. Back out to Green. Catch and release corner three. Bounces down. How about that? So hot against the Suns.
Ball movement helps him in Thompson. And then your guy has to go help it.
Green to the rim.
Got ice in his veins.
Fred and Jalen have combined for a triple-double this game. Turnover, two on one. Fred to Green.
Jalen, this is the best game we have seen from Jalen. Forget what we saw the other night.
Oh, I yes.
Out on the break, and Jalen Green moonwalking, man. That is sweet right there, jumping over. Game gets this tight. You have to finish your opportunities.
He's made a couple of threes now, six-point game. Rockets, seven more made threes in this one, as you see. Green into the paint, over the shoulder, gets it to go somehow.
Again, Green driving. Look at him searching out the contact here. Excellent footwork to get the layup. And
was on the previous play when it appeared that you're going to get to the basket. You're not going to get that cleanly. Nice job by Miles. Really nice job with the body. But they're able to do that. Watch Miles. He goes into the body and it forced.
Siakam drives. Turner in the corner to tie it.
Good patience there on Miles. Sometimes big people make it because he can do this too. He missed it, but he can do that.
Baseball pass, Halliburton to Turner, who flushes it home.
Bedtime pass there. And if you do, you can get some good things. That pass is there.
Hardaway with his second field goal, his first two. Turner catches down the lane, left hand, basket, and a foul by Gafford.
Action early, get into it quicker. See how high Miles Turner is up? So they get the screen up there. Miles has become better at handling the ball, so he can get it, get down here that time. I saw Mark last night. And he's pretty happy with what he was able to pull off. Confident shooting there by Miles Turner. Nice movement. That's the way the ball has to move.
A 20-point. Nembhard puts it on the ground.
You are not going to get to the basket. He did the right thing. Draw it, kick it. That's what you're going to do. You're not getting to the basket. And what the Pacers are doing now, really good job here. Playing physical because you're going to have to do it. But he drew down.
Halliburton had a 12-point first half. Here's Turner again. Goes inside left hand. All of a sudden, the lead is down to four. Pacers led by as many as 11. Here's Turner, steps into another jumper.
Three Mavericks there, and somehow Mathurin came up with it.
Turner to the basket, lays it in. He's got 30.